Damn you, YouTube. Damn you, videos on a radio
right,
show.
Right, Scotty and Boof.
Scotty Dance. And Boof.
Boof.
You want to take our first break?
I think your name is Boof.
Oh, no, we're still going. Cool. I thought we started at 5 o'clock. Wait, what's that drop?
Yeah, we can take a break in a minute. I just want to see if we get this Boof thing.
Man. What is that?
You missed it. You missed a lot of drops from yesterday.
Here we go. That's it.
And add one thing.
Sure, Jacob.
Because I feel like I came off very bad the last 10 minutes.
Definitely.
I would like to say my favorite quote from Tina Yothers.
It's not, I think the hair is only part of it. I think it's just a lot of stuff because my surgery, I haven't been able to work out, so I don't feel good about my look in general.
Sure.
So I think it's just compounding things. It was one or the other. No, I mean, Jay.
You get that clean, Lou?
I haven't been able to work out.
That was the best.
I haven't been able to work out, so I don't look
as jacked as you normally
look.
Don't buy.
That bums me
out. Are you worried you're not filling out your shirts the way you used to?
Jay, this is getting off the topic a little, but my all-time favorite quote from anyone on IMDb is from the actress Katie Lotz. Who's on the CW's Legends of Tomorrow?
Sick.
Of course.
Jesus fucking Christ.
And her... the quote is...
How much does the subscription cost you?
I don't know why I love this
celebrities
quote.
Celebrities that nobody give a fuck about.
I swear to God, the knob broke. Jacob was watching Renegade in 1987, and his channel never changed. All he knows is that video. He knows Vampire Diaries, One Tree Hill.
You watch Dawson's Creek at night?
Airwolf. Started watching all the CW shows because I got to unwind at night. Look, I don't. They're so bad that
That's not even a reason, let alone an excuse.
It makes me. I don't.
Do you laugh at them?
They're terrible.
So I'm saying, are they laughably bad? Is that what
you
enjoy? I get that. There's plenty of things I watch like to hate, laugh at.
Yeah.
Don't.
The writing's bad, but I dig her. But the quote is, I don't know why I find this so funny. I love it when a guy compliments my vibe. Yeah.
I get it. It's really...
It's a great line. It's my favorite quote.
Right, Fred just walked by, and I could be right.
I think you are right.
I don't know if I'm right at all, but I could be right.
Or Mac from Mac and Me got jacked.
Is that right, said Fred? Go ask them if they are. Ask them if they're too sexy for our show. Oh, my
love. I don't think that...
Jacob, I asked the guys maybe go out there and be wrong and call them right, said Fred.
And I hope you get punched in your khaki. Right in his chest. Right in his 65 push-up chest.
Are you dressed for a date tonight?
Where are you going? Let me tell you. Going down the bar, having a couple drinks with a woman friend.
I'll tell you where you're going. Home to whack off with that personality.
I'd love to see Jacob just fly into the wall. Just fucking.
And they go over and just lay a mesh shirt over his face. Good day.
Dude, he's not coming back.
Right side Fred's fucking him.
running a devil's threesome on Jacob.
They're just fucking spit roasting Jacob out there.
But I had a date.
No.
No.
I thought that the promise was cheese.
Dude, where is he?
I don't know.
Merc face, we gotta send you out there to do some beat poetry.
You take my friend, you take him, he disappears.
Oh, they just walked in the other direction.
He's coming back defeated.
Oh. He looks like a professor that just got let go.
Now I feel terrible.
Oh, sorry you're not tenured, professor. Did the dean just let you go? Who is it?
Was it right, said Fred?
No.
It wasn't?
How did you open it?
It was the most uncomfortable conversation.
I feel... dude, you know what? You got rejection out of your fucking butt now, dude.
You can't be any worse than that.
It's like any weirder than that.
It's called pain misdirection.
That was horrific.
What happened?
I realized I didn't know if it was him. And I said... the guys on the show we just saw you pass by and they're really big fans.
Great.
And then I said, and I realized I didn't know if it was him. And I said, who are you?
And who was
No, I did. I said, I just want to make sure you're who I think you are. And it's the DJ who's on the air here.
Oh, shit. That is great.
Yes, I am. I am turquoise.
DJ Jacob, turquoise. You would have been like, I'll give you $100 to walk in there and please just pretend you're right, said Fred.
Please,
God.
Yeah, because I'll tell you this. We would have bought it.
I'm mortified.
Oh, dude, that's so great.
No, but now you got it. That's it. That's and the first lick. You're good now.
Listen, you can look at this in one of two ways. You can look at this as, yeah, that guy's in the building consistently.
You knew him and you just let me die out there.
Yeah, I knew that was liquid Todd.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Lou, points to you.
That was the most flannel shirt over a t-shirt thing you've done since you've worked here.
Let me tell you.
I'm not going to stand in the way of a bit.
Now, when we last left you, Jacob, fresh off a very daunting experience of falsely accusing Liquid Todd of being right said Fred.
Yeah, Jacob got to meet Liquid Todd in the worst way possible.
Liquid Todd, by the way, you see he laid down a nice little tweet?
Yeah, that's your producer.
That's fucking, that's Radio War. You didn't see his tweet?
Yeah.
He goes, wait a second, because I guess someone told him what happened. And he goes, so that guy, so that nervous guy in the hallway was your quote unquote producer. Yikes. And now we got a beef with fucking Liquid Todd.
I mean, come on, man. Jacob's a good dude. You
Jacob's
don't know
great
him
like
dude. That. He was nervous.
I was.
Cause you know what? You'd be nervous if you thought you were meeting right said Fred.
Liquid Todd.
And this is coming from
if
a huge
If you thought you were meeting right said Fred, you'd be shaking. Oh, I think he composed himself pretty well.
It's like meeting a president.
Which was so, man, that was so fantastic.
I realized as soon as he turned around, I was not dealing with right said Fred.
That's the best.
But the thing that had shot out of my mouth before I even could say anything was, my hosts are really big fans of yours. And then it was too late.
It's too late. You, and also you were doing this dressed like you were going to junior prom. Today you're dressed like the ghost of the guy who drag raced my father and spun out and died in 1957.
Yeah, he's got
and he's
like
back to haunt me.
Dead older uncle. This was my brother, Julio. He died before you were born.
We used to sing doo-wop on the stoop.
Hey, look at him. Yeah, he's just got a white tee and some jeans.
Fucking fantastic.
Oh, we're shutting the door. I forgot our door's open.
We gave him a fantastic story to walk over to what was
a blind date.
A blind date that he hadn't been on anything, he said, in 15 years.
Isn't I hadn't something like been that? On a blind date in a long time.
Yeah, long, long time.
Who was in office the last time you went on a blind date? Was it George W? Or was
I think it, was
Clinton?
Clinton, yeah.
Wow.
Last year.
Shit. Backstreet Boys concert.
Yeah.
But we brought you over here because now it's time to talking about Jacob.
Talking about getting sweet, sweet pussy.
Talking about Jacob. I'm about to let you all down.
Talking about Jacob. Talking about Jacob. Getting that sweet, sweet pussy. Talking about Jacob.
Yeah,
we can harmonize. What happened, dude?
By the way, that's going to be a lot of people are going to be singing that in their head when they get out of the car.
You're welcome for that.
It's going to be like the chicken parm. I love you so much.
Yeah. Fuck you, Peyton Manning. We got our own jam.
Talking about Jacob.
Talking about
sweet, sweet pussy. Talking about Jacob.
I was hanging in the office, and all of a sudden Lou just started singing, talking about Jacob.
Oh, dude.
Talking about sweet, sweet pussy.
Talking about Jacob. Busting that shit open. Talking about Jacob. Jacob. Getting that sweet, sweet pussy. Do we have a drop of that?
Talking about Jacob. Getting sweet, sweet pussy.
Talking about Jacob.
Getting that sweet, sweet pussy.
Talking about Jacob. I've added levels. I've added layers to it now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You've been doing some remixes?
Yeah. Talking about Jacob. Getting that sweet, sweet pussy. Talking about Jacob. The second one's got to go.
Yeah, Jacob.
The second one starts lower.
You know what I do sometimes? And Jacob, I don't think about you all the time in the shower, but sometimes I do when I add a rap verse to that.
Really?
Talking about Jacob. Talking about sweet, sweet pussy. My name is Jacob and I'm here to say that getting strange pussy is A-okay. I like cheese and I like to bang.
Nah, see, this is B-fit.
Her pubes are thinning out.
Yeah.
She's getting that freckle chest.
Thin pube hair. That's great. Did you
Make a duty in jail? I mean, what do you
Make it, dude.
Make it, dude.
I mean, I don't know what to say. Wow. It's just
what
how
the
you
fuck?
Take a shit. Like if just you're in a jail, he's saying,
"How do you make a duty at home?" Oh,
no,
Ali used to make all of his cellmates shit standing up.
Oh, there she is.
No, but not.
Is that her?
Make a duty.
That would be a great thing if Ali made all of his cellmates shit standing up and piss sitting down.
Handstand today, baby.
Somebody would always leave.
Wow.
Yeah. Someone you would. You try to do it.
Oh, you stare at that camel toe.
You try to do it when your cellmate gone, but if you don't, you take a towel, your towel, put your towel over you.
Jacob, I don't even want to fuck up the quote of what you just said so tender and seriously.
We were talking about Daisy Fuentes and Richard Marx, and we were showing pictures of their wedding, and you tenderly said what?
It was a freshly hatched chick. It was so cute.
She said, their lovemaking must be beautiful.
Lovemaking?
I bet their lovemaking.
No, he said. He goes. I bet their lovemaking.
Like he pictured it. He pictured.
I bet he holds her.
Come on.
Softly, but also powerful.
Like a bed with posts.
That's too beautiful a couple.
I'm hung up.
They make beauty. They make love like that video.
Jacob, when's the last time you doled out some justice with your hands?
Meh.
33.
When you were 33?
Yeah.
Who'd you fight?
Who was it?
I'm ashamed to admit it. I was working at a restaurant, and this guy would not leave me alone.
Are you ashamed that you were working at a restaurant at 33?
And, yeah, it was this guy who would just yell at the restaurant at me, and I said...
Was he a customer?
No, he was a fellow employee.
Yeah, and he was just another waiter?
Double shift, and I said, well, let's fight this out at the end of the shift. So I had to work the whole shift knowing I was going to get into a street fight afterward.
Why would you do that?
Just say it after the shift.
I like Jacob
taking
distracted orders where he goes, all right, so you had...
Just looking at him.
He goes, the pot roast. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. He's right behind me, isn't he?
No, I think he's half looking at... He's always looking at that guy the whole time. He goes, okay, it's two deep dish pies.
He goes, no, I got it. Diet Coke. Yeah, I bet he bleeds.
Hey, real quick question. You see that guy walking back to the kitchen? Do you think he has bitch in his heart?
Yeah.
And you, miss, you wanted the... Look at that fucking prick.
How did it go down? Were you guys talking chin as you rolled silverware?
I mean, we were taking aprons off.
Yeah.
We worked the shift for the next 5 hours, and then it was quiet.
Your fist
there were
up.
People eating at the... But we had served them all, so we went out right in front to the right of the entrance of the restaurant in the middle on Madison Avenue. And we squared off, and the last time I'd been in a fight was second grade.
Wow.
And were you 1-0?
And I just knew that I...
Were you 1-0 from second grade?
I used to win in second. Yeah.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Everyone still talks about that. Jacob was a terror in second grade.
Still a thing.
Dude, you go back where he grew up, and like that guy was a nightmare when he was 7 years old.
They ran him out of Florida.
People don't forget.
After that, everyone grew taller than me. And I never fought again.
So what happened when you went on Madison?
You squared up.
I said, my only instinct was, I got to hit this guy first.
Hell yeah.
And so
strike first, strike hard.
And I went twice in the face. I jabbed him in the face, and he went, ah!
Really?
And I went, oh. And then I kind of got scared, like, oh, my God, what the fuck did I just do?
Jacob! Yeah!
Dude, I was waiting for Jacob to say some psycho shit where he goes,
so I knew I had to take him down, so I grabbed a bottle, and I broke it over his head. And, anyways, I think I should stop telling the story now.
Goes,
it's going to be hard to yell at me without a voice box.
So just giving a little poke in his throat. He goes, Jacob's not serious. I'm sorry, I won't yell anymore. He goes,
Jacob.
I thought you were going to say that.
Jab, and then I punched him.
You get into one-one-two?
And then I freaked out because he was starting to cry.
What?
And so I kind of stopped. And I was like, I'm not hitting this guy, and I let him tackle me. And then we kind of wrestled till I just kind of held him, and then people broke us up.
Oh, nice.
Why? Because you can't have gay sex in public?
My humanity rushed. rushed into back. And
he goes, Jacob,
he
goes,
is this what you wanted the whole time, to be held?
Oh, you wanted was a hug, buddy.
He goes, I fucking love you!
Can I tell you, we became friends after that.
Of really? Course you did! And he goes, you shared the queerest moment you've ever had in your life together.
And rolling
around the street.
It just was like, Lewitsky!
I'm not fucking with Jacob. He'll help.
me on the ground.
Yeah, yeah, you never know. He's going to hold you down and hug you for a while.
Jacob looks at Louis and goes, you need to be cuddled.
That's fucking hilarious.
Well, I won my last fight.
All right.
Long story short.
Undefeated.
Yeah, that's it. He's undefeated.
Yeah, undefeated Jacob Atat.
And by the way, decades between fights.
Yeah, well, we're coming to you live from the comedy office because Jerk Off Jacob forgot to book us a studio.
I swear to God, I hope he's getting eaten in Florida right now by a shark.
I hope he loses a leg.
What's that?
I hope he's in a gator fight.
Oh,
right,
that'd
now
be awesome. They go, no, let the gator have him.
Just the gator roll?
This Jew gonna get chewed on up by a gator.
It's the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big Jokerson. That handsome voice is Dan Soder.
Oh, hey, dude. Oh, hey, dude.
No Jacob. Jacob left and fucking shoved it right up our ass.
As I said right before the show starts, when the mouse is away, the cats will play. Let's go through his stuff.
Oh, does he have stuff?
Yeah. So let's go through his desk.
Oh, what if it's just like a bar, like cat heads and shit?
Oh, doll eyes? Just a whole jar of doll eyes? And you're like, Jacob, what is that? He goes, it gives me feelings.
He's got a bunch of failed experiment naked women in his attic or something. Yeah.
Don't go to Astoria.
I heard you live by yourself, but I didn't know it was like that.
No, it's they all love me.
I'm going to bring them back to life.
I feed them Wendy's and McDonald's.
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
Oh, dude. That,
wow.
That episode hasn't played yet. So that out of context is real harsh. Oh,
fucking pussy. Fucking faggot. I love Christine and I bake.
Angry Jacob. God damn it, Lou.
I love Christine and I bake.
What a perfect.
I love Christine and I bake.
Oh, and then Christine, I'm good at Shakespeare. That's if Christine left the show. If Jacob and Christine ran away together.
Man, that is really out of context.
Also, Angry Jacob just sounds funny.
Yeah, oh yeah.
It's just great finding out that, like, if he has... Like, when he just texted us, he's like, hey, have a good show, homos. And you're like, shut up, Jacob. Like,
is that your own?
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
But that's new. This is new Jacob.
Jesus, that's a shot of fucking stiff whiskey right there.
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
Lou, you were up late last night.
God damn. Were you drunk in front of a keyboard with noisemakers going, that's almost it. I almost got him. What if we did nail it and an aggressive Jacob didn't like it?
I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot.
So bad.
I tell you what, can I tell you the context of that really quick?
Sure.
I was like, Jacob, I go, what do you think about that chick over there?
Yeah.
And that's what he said.
Yeah, and I go, Jacob, what do you think of, like, your superiors at Sirius?
Too many fucking faggots in this city.
Oh, Jesus. Wow. Wow.
What if he gets canned along with Opie? They just put the file in it. Like, you know when they pass a bill and they put another one under it? They're like, how's this fire, Jacob, too?
Might as well get him out of there.
I'd be bummed.
Fucking pussy.
All right, Jacob.
Jesus, Jacob. All right, you leave
I'm just, all right, I'm on the street. I'm at a red light. I'm waiting to cross the street. There's actually two guys next to me. There's this big black guy standing next to me, and then there's a Latino guy next to him.
So it's a robbery.
Randomly.
So this is a robbery setup, clearly.
Yeah, he goes, which one do I give my wallet to, and who do I plead for my life for?
That's how he walks up to the red light.
Latino asks for directions, and then the black guy goes to your pockets. So it's a gypsy crime.
Yeah, but or Jacob just, that's what he does. He just comes with him and goes,
I know how this works. Please, no violence to my face.
Can I take my keys and credit cards? I'm going to cancel them anyway.
I'd prefer to hold on to my driver's license and my keys. It's not like you guys are going to go to my apartment and get all my Jaws memorabilia.
Wait, what happened? So, but across the street, as we're waiting for the light, I noticed there's a gorgeous girl, all right?
What'd she look like?
Big rag, you would have loved her.
Okay.
Long brown hair.
All right.
Hourglass figure. I mean, in a sea full of tens in the city in the summer, she was an 11.
Wow.
She really did stand out.
That almost sounds like lyrics from Jacob's Diary.
In a sea full of tens, she was an 11.
I mean, she's just noticeably beautiful. Okay. You got to know
this
that.
Is in Astoria.
In Astoria.
All right.
So.
I'll keep my eyes open.
The light turns. I mean, that's it. They noticed her, too. They had to have.
Yeah.
So.
Well, she's got
tits and ass and gorgeous. The ethnics.
Yeah.
They love that.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. So as the light turns, we all start walking. The three of us start walking up the street. She just passes us. That's
Does it turn into a musical? You go,
Miss, where are you going? I want to talk to you.
I wish. So as soon as the girl passes by, the black guy yells out loud, too many fucking faggots in this city.
Which one?
The black guy.
Oh, I thought the girl.
No.
She walks by and she just looks at all three of them. She goes, what's up, queefs?
Yeah. Hey, fag. So the black guy.
As soon as she passed by us, that's what he yells. And then he says it again. You're all a bunch of fucking faggots in this city. And then we're still walking in unison.
Where's he from?
He turns-
Foxville? He's like, oh, where I'm from, all we do is fuck pussy all the
crush
time.
Crush ass.
Well, then he turns to me as we're walking and goes, you're a fucking faggot.
To you?
Yeah, and then he turns to the Latino guy on his side and he goes, you a fucking faggot, fucking pussy. And the Latino guy does exactly what I do.
But he goes,
he looks straight ahead and keeps walking as if none of this is going
He goes, sir, let I argue with you that... There, you can be a faggot and love a woman.
I am no homosexual.
I have been with a man strictly for warmth.
Oh, homosexuality.
And the Canary Islands.
The reason I bring
what
it up
Puerto Rican, what did the Latino guy look like?
He was shorter than me in his 40s. So he wasn't... You're this Mr. guy was Mr. saying no to problem. Two people he knew he was not going to have any problems with.
Y'all short little faggots.
Now, when you say big black guy...
He was...
Are we talking, like, heavy?
6'3 and just jacked.
He jacked.
Built.
Well, we know where that situation. We know what that motivation is in the gym, where he's like, I ain't no fucking faggot.
Yeah.
Yes, you are. Just let it go.
But here's my theory, because I'm telling... This is what's been... I've been thinking about...
I'm walking around Queens looking for all these queens. I'm going to smash them all up. Damn borough named after y'all.
You want to kiss this big old dick, pretty boy?
Yeah. I bet you cross the street looking at that pretty lady going, I wish she had a big old black dick between her legs.
I don't want to get it.
Oh, no. I'm going to make you take this right here by this fresh fish farm.
My mouth doesn't open that way.
Pretty ironic that we're in front of this fresh fish company.
Because we were talking about on 31st.
And I know what just passed it. With the blue.
Yep.
Yes.
He really did.
It looks like the sea. The guy.
What he said, he was on 30th Avenue by the fruit market, and he said he was walking. I knew he was by a fish market.
You might as well start holding hands with that Hispanic guy.
He goes,
he must have seen us come out. He must have seen us come out of the fruit market.
Yeah, we're boyfriends now.
Story, you can't miss it because, I cannot describe it. But,
so,
my theory is this guy's brain shorted out because he saw this girl, and I feel like he wanted to tell the world, I'm the only guy who could fuck this girl. Everyone's a fucking faggot compared to me. He was just so angry. She was so hot.
You're saying she was so hot. She made him homophobic.
She made him lose his mind. Yeah.
Girl.
Well, you and that Hispanic guy together probably could have held her down.
But I mean, my brain processed her the right way. I mean, as soon as she passed, I went, she's smoking hot. And then
did you
felt pain inside that I was never going to see her again.
Do you bring your sunglasses down over the bridge of your nose as she walked by? I went, oh, yeah.
So
they're walking the stage. Jacob's like,
well, look at her.
Look at her crossing the street.
So you're going to go up here and make a right, and then you're going to see a church and ga-ga-ga-ga. Hold the effing phone.
Exactly what it was.
Who is this?
Did an angel just fall from the heavens?
And then that gets interrupted.
Hey! Too many faggots up in here.
What a buzzkill.
That's exactly what happened. I was wearing glasses. He totally ripped me out of my moment.
It'd be great if he just grabbed you and Hispanic guy and just wedgied you both and carried you across the street by your underwear.
Jacob's leaving the fruit market and he goes,
a high school moment.
Jacob's leaving and he goes,
I can't believe they don't have fresh papaya. That's crazy for Monday. Well, red light. Who is this? Oh, brunette, hourglass figure.
Feels like my pants are getting tighter.
Oh, I gotta go to the gym, but I might have to make a stop at the old spank bank first. Oh.
Dan, it was a high school flashback, because it's me in the hallway. I see a hot chick, I'm just drooling over, and then all of a sudden I hear, hey, Patat!
Yeah.
Fucking faggot!
Yeah. First, the most important thing of the day, let's bring it up. Happy birthday to Jacob Attard.
Happy birthday, Jacob.
Happy birthday, Jacob.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
You tried hiding it, didn't you? You pulled a Lewitsky. You tried hiding your birthday. Black Lou, when's your birthday?
I'm not good with my birthday.
March 7th.
Hell yeah, that's a good birthday. Be up front with it so we can celebrate it. These two
assholes.
How many
cock slaps do we give you, Jacob?
How many little tummy taps? How many tummy taps do you want?
What birthday is it?
48.
Jesus, yeah. You look great. By the way, he got a haircut. He didn't do the shaved head, but with the beard, the sides. Dude, Jacob looks great.
Yeah. The beard's nice.
Yeah.
I'm digging the beard.
Looking great, dude. Did you know you're going to go into 48 this sexy?
No.
Yeah. Happy birthday, Jacob.
Thank you, man.
Happy birthday, Jacob.
Happy birthday, Jacob.
We got you. Yo, Jay and I got you a gift. You know, it's like...
She loves me.
Yeah.
Hey, give me a beer. Now give me a smooch. Bring me over that shark tooth.
I get a lot of puss.
Yeah, damn right.
Dude, you know what I love about this, Jay? This is the first time we've been separated where Lou has his accurate AI Jacob drops. So there will be some stuff that catches you off guard.
Puss.
Oh, I really thought that was you trying to start the sentence. That fucked me up, but I'm in the room with him. Oh. He definitely strikes me as the guy. He lives in New York. He strikes me as the guy that will look at his phone on the way up the stairs of the subway.
Jacob gets a real under-the-skin hatred for pretty guys.
Pretty, beautiful men.
Like pretty guys.
You don't like beautiful men.
I'll tell you why.
Where am I on your spectrum?
Because if he was honest about he's just on here.
For pussy?
On the documentary.
Yeah.
Just saying how I get a lot of puss, then I'd be fine with it.
Because you are the answer. Lend me your love. Lend me your love tonight.
I'll marry you right now.
Perfect drop. What was the moment that broke you?
It was cum shot. There were so many, and then the one time
cum shot hit the wall so hard it knocked his picture off the other side of the wall.
No, not Mima. Not Mima Batas.
One time I couldn't sleep, so I always wanted to stay in my room because it was so uncomfortable, but I was just did a double shift, and
yeah,
I wanted to go and watch TV and unwind.
You didn't want a hot girl coming in and being like, who are you?
That's what happened the one time. I said, I'm just going to watch TV because I can't be a prisoner in my room for this.
Yeah.
There was no window. There was no TV in my room. I just had the bed.
So you just had the bed. So the TV.
So I had to go outside in the living room, which is right where they walk in.
And you don't want to be there when they walk in.
This was post, so I'm. They had already gone into his bedroom, and I could hear them banging. But I was I'm adamant. I'm not going into my room. I want to watch TV.
Was the sound worse in your room? Okay, yeah, I'm sorry.
Half an hour later, the door opens, and this girl walks out. To this day, I'll never forget. It's the greatest ass I've ever seen. She's just wearing her underwear and a T-shirt. And I thought I was going to die. It was a New York 9, but in the real life in my apartments. And yeah. She just goes like this. Hi. And I went, hi.
Are you the Make-A-Wish kid that he said he takes care of?
Oh, my God. BB, you've got a sad puppy on your couch.
Are you his retarded brother he takes care of?
She was so nice. I thought... I'll marry you right now.
Yeah.
That's all I want. She goes,
you should have said that out loud.
I'll take you away.
I wish you would have said that.
She goes,
hey, are you lost, little weirdo? He goes,
I'll marry you right now.
I'll walk away from everything and marry you.
Excuse me?
She goes, I'm going to have to call the cops, though, because you're freaking me out.
Yeah, she's my God. Okay, I'm going to pepper spray you if you don't get the fuck away from me.
Hey, baby, that runaway boy in your living room is threatening me.
Your pet ferret's talking.
Couldn't have been nicer, but it was... That one broke me.
Oh, dude, yeah.
And then she went back in, and then the next morning, he came out.
A different girl came out.
She left. But he gives me the, he walks out. He was so bored from fucking, you know, he was like, yeah, we banged her. And I, all I could think about was like... her ass. And then he acted frustrated. He went, yeah, I was banging her from behind. And then she took it out and put it in her ass. And I went, ah!
Dude, that's so, I mean, dude, that's like Handsome Pete. Handsome Pete lived with us.
Moaning I used to hear from these women.
Really?
Like, if it makes sense.
My paper thin wall.
Oh, would it wake you up?
No. See, I got back from the restaurant because I wasn't picking up any. So I got home from a double shift at like 2 in the morning.
Yeah.
And he would get back at 3 with them an hour later.
Yeah. Right, I was going to say, then it's John Leguizamo. It's John Leguizamo.
And then I would have to hear them.
It's Anthony Byrne. It's Antonio Banderas.
But I broke one time and I couldn't take it anymore. So
back to the 3 a.m. He would come home at 3 a.m. with a girl, and then would you be asleep?
I would be in my room just waiting for it because I couldn't bear it. I didn't want to.
Dick in hand?
No, I never did. It was the worst. Jay, I cried when he broke and there was a tear coming down my temple. I was so miserable.
Was it a tear, though?
A single tear. My life sucks.
Was it a frustration? I've had a frustration tear before.
Yeah.
1283, I can't remember the goddamn name of this channel. I had written it down with my massive notes.
Hi, Jacob. It's me, your and sleep channel.
I see on the guide, back to back to back, I see Airwolf. And I went, oh, my God, in the first time in 30 years, I'm going to watch this show. I click on it, that episode. It's already in progress. It's the new Airwolf.
Ah! Oh, nice. Did you stick with it?
It's so bad. No, I hadn't seen the season. Uh-huh. And it's a whole new cast. It's horrifically shitty. And then I read up on it.
Get back to trashing Stringfellow Hawk. My favorite pilot.
I loved String. But well, here's what I'm happened. The show goes on, and I watched it diligently, and then they cancel it. I had no idea at that young age, I think, what cancellation was. What do you mean it's not on anymore?
So anyway, you became a nihilist?
Yeah. I didn't believe in anything.
I was miserable, but then I hear in the paper there's no internet. They're bringing back Airwolf. So I'm beyond happy. And then the pilot episode of the new Airwolf, it turns out, totally new cast. The only person that comes back is Jan Michael Vincent, who I learned was such a raging alcoholic that he probably needed the money.
Get me Airwolf!
He was actually a guest on Howard 15 years after the show was canceled, and I was horrified at the shape of him. He's the best looking guy ever. He was the good looking young guy in Hooper. He was Burt Reynolds.
So this is your hero. This is your guy.
Yeah, but he was a heartthrob. He was the young guy Reynolds was supposed to be intimidated by in Hooper. That's how good looking this guy was. And then now he's a train wreck. I should.
What?
I left something about our Airwolf discussion.
Oh, yeah, okay, go ahead.
Say it now or forever hold your peace.
You remember when I told you I was rather upset when the show was canceled?
You didn't threaten to kill.
You wrote a letter.
I still think about this. Because, like I said, there's no internet. I read this in a magazine. And my poor mother, in front of her, had a tantrum. I took the magazine and I threw it across the room. I said, they can't do this!
That's when I knew my little bubbles was gay.
And I just always weird. Felt bad. Like, she must have thought at that moment, well, no. Why did I become a mom?
No, man. I mean, how old were you?
Passionate.
I was a young teenager.
Like under 14?
No.
Jacob, for the love of God.
I was 22.
I was 26 years old. I just came back from Florida.
I was way too old to give a shit.
They can't do this is a great
thing. They can't do this! No! Don't you understand? I am Airwolf. They changed Darren's in the middle of Bewitched. No! I don't know, and I don't like Al Bundy's new neighbor!
If you're wondering why Jacob's not in the studio. He's right now, he's out in the window spinning with his arms extended going.
He goes, don't worry, guys. I'm just hovering. Any sign of conflict and I'll blow him up.
Time to wolf out.
Oh, no. I got to go up to my secret mountain in Montana.
That's what we call his office.
I got to go to my secret Airwolf lair.
Have you ever come in? Blues, have you guys ever gone... gone into the studio, and he's in one of these chairs, like, spinning it around wildly. Going,
it'd be great to catch him in his apartment, naked, in a helmet.
Hey, Dom. Hey, Dom. Ernie Borgnine here.
Hey, Lou. I'm asking you, will you be my Ernest Borgnine?
Will you be my Dom?
Will you be my Dom? Cinderella?
You're his Dom for his Airwolf.
Yeah.
Look at Junkie Jacob, everybody.
Oh, my God. There he is. Oh, my God.
He's fucking strung out.
Why is he so depressed? Why are you walking so mopey?
He's not depressed at all, man. He's feeling nice.
He just took a pill out of fucking Jay's pocket.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I fucking diving boarded into his mouth off my dickhead. We have to make it creepy in here. Jacob, you feeling it?
You all right, buddy?
Yeah.
Why, what did you take?
Oh, he gave him a pill that looked like an everlasting gobstopper.
It's an everlasting gobstopper, placebo effect. Yeah. No, I gave him a painkiller. He's hurt.
Why? What's wrong?
He gave him a pill.
He's
made
a little
of
depressed.
He gave him a pill made of a piece of Joe Rogan's brain.
What's his bone marrow?
Yeah, it's Joe Rogan's bone marrow. Right now he's hunting.
Yeah, you're gonna be running with deer later. Although God knows what Jacob's gonna be capable of now. I made him a heroin addict last week. So.
No, I heard. I came in. Look at his truck stop look.
Oh, he's been jonesing since. I know he has been. He's never taken a painkiller in his life.
Did you sleep like a baby that night?
I felt great. I wanted to ask you. I mean, can you just have another one?
God damn it, Jay. You got him on.
Well, Jacob, here's the thing, though. It's like that first taste was completely free.
Hey, go, Jacob, now. Jake, now what are you going to do for
we'll
us?
Talk later.
Yeah.
Jacob goes.
Oh, Jacob wants another shot at that
time. Hey, what if I told you? I'm going to tell you a secret. Sirius has been running the show at half juice.
What do you mean?
They're not going full go. Give me another one of your little candy pills. Everyone hears the bonfire.
Jacob's got
you, I get it now.
Yeah.
Of course.
It's a fucking opiate, dude. Oh. Dude, if you start ripping butts, if Jacob starts taking pills and ripping butts, he's going to be 14-year-old me.
Will you talk about, didn't you go out afterwards?
Yeah.
Will you tell us about, can we tell you what that
Did
was?
Did you nod off into the soup?
Because I was curious how that went.
It didn't go anywhere. But no. I felt fine.
Jacob was meeting. Jacob was going out on a date. I sent him in junked up on a date.
She goes, Jacob, your left eyelid is closing.
Your left eyelid's closing.
If you get near me, I'll stab you in your throat, you stupid bitch.
I'm sorry, I'm kidding. Hey,
are you itchy?
I'm itchy. Are you keep going in your purse? Is there any change down there at the bottom of that at all?
Do you have any Oxycontin?
I'm on drugs!
Hey, happen to notice, when you went to the bathroom, you left your purse a little open there. I saw you had a couple prescription pills in there. Is there anything fun, or is it all like real shit?
Is it the herp, or is it herp or happy? You get it.
I am a golden god!
he was feeling nice. When he left, he was feeling nice.
Dude, you can't.
I didn't feel bad on the day. Like, you know, sometimes it doesn't go well, the date. It's a first date, but I mean,
yeah.
She wasn't into it. I wasn't into it.
But you were just smacked
but
up.
But I was like, this is great.
Yeah.
I felt nothing.
You're like, you know what? We both got it out of our systems early. We both know. Why continue? Why waste the rest of our nights when I can go home and just jam out to some Floyd?
Because this is the clearest thing ever. I got a carpet. I got a rug at my house that I want to lay on top of and just... Just
Jacob making shag angels from a Doors album.
Jay, 6 hours later, I need that pill. Yeah, dude, you gotta get off it, dude. Yeah. I mean, how bad do you want another one?
Airwolf.
I would take it.
No, he would take another one for sure.
I think he's saying he will take one.
I'll hook you up, Jake. I'll get you a little something.
Don't.
I did mention the two of you, and I got aggravated when she... Something she said about you, Dan.
What'd she say?
Because I had mentioned you were on Billions, and I get very defensive about the two of you. I said, you know, I work with these two comics. They're great comics. One of them's on... Because she's... I said, do you see the show Billions? I love that show.
Yeah.
I said, the guy I know is on that show.
He's making it all spacey.
See?
Jacob's story
spacey. He
goes,
yeah. Isn't there, like, a big part on it, right?
Bitch.
It was over there.
Thank you, Jacob.
He's in the universe. There are no small parts.
Who's got small
That's
parts? Who's got small parts? I mean...
Under as zonked out as I was, I kind of went... No, I mean, it's a fairly big part.
Actually, the part's growing, you fucking whore bag.
Because it's called... Aren't you familiar with storylines, you cunt?
He goes, it's a developing character.
He goes, you know, sometimes people in the back come to the front.
The other
Jacob,
guy...
Jacob, are you nodding out on me?
The other guy's the joke. He was only in one episode for one scene.
I'm sorry. Can we get our check? My date's asleep.
I haven't slept in 3 days. I'm sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Your hair looks like it would be a great pillow.
Are you on fire? Or am I on fire? Shine on you, crazy diamond. By the way, we got 15 more minutes of that background, that backdrop, before that changes at all.
I
could do heroin Jacob forever.
He goes, it's a minimal part, but they need him on set. Record.
It's called,
what do you say?
It's called background continuity, you fucking square.
Why don't you work 3 jobs? See how big your role is.
Oh, I'm sorry. What show did you go do a big part on?
Are you on HBO? Then why are you coming to me with that star's mouth?
Oh, my bad. My bad, Tracy Ullman. I didn't realize you were running.
I'm sorry. Hey, Eddie Murphy and Naughty Professor. I didn't know you played all the parts.
They're on the smart part. On the smart part.
Showtime.
Who's this bitch think she is?
Showtime on demand.
I'm lost.
Season 3, March 25th.
Mama? Papa?
Sharks?
Mom, why are there so many dolls in this room?
I love sharks.
My dolls. Dolls.
I want to swim.
They're dolls.
I want to swim.
Look at me.
I want to swim deep.
They can't do this!
What are you guys even talking about, man?
He goes,
beauty's everywhere.
I'm still on my date.
Your name again? It doesn't matter. You're pure energy.
You say it's a smart, small role again. I'll take this butter knife and jam it into your esophagus.
I didn't make us a 7:30 reservation at Houlihan's to not eat their beer batter shrimp.
Jacob, how did you leave it with her? He goes, let me score some good shit. Maybe we'll meet up again.
Nowhere.
He goes, you want to be my Nancy to my sitting Nancy?
Where'd you meet her at?
It was a bar uptown.
No, I mean, where did you, like, what was
this, an app?
What set it up? It was an app date?
Yeah.
Off one of the apps? Which one? Bumble?
Yeah.
So she reached out to you first?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah, dog. Are all your pictures just fucking abs?
Yeah, dude, you better go ab heavy. You better go fucking torso heavy on that profile.
Hell yeah.
Airwolfing it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm in the sky right now. I'm zooted up here.
Oh, man.
Hey, just me and Ernie Borgnine. Sailing through the blue skies. He goes, what are in these magic pills? Can they call them airwolves?
He goes, I've never been more in tune with everything at once.
I feel like I'm hovering.
He goes, I'm not stepping on the floor. The floor is becoming part of me.
This is going to sound crazy, but give me a cello. I can play. God damn it, I can play.
Give me pen, give me paper. I'm going to write every note to this song down. F-L-G-D and F-Y-G.
Starts Justin Silvering it. 4, 5, 5.
B-B-B-G major. G major.
You know what the funny part about me and the machine is? You don't care about anything else.
We're all just cogs in it, man. Doing our part. We're all just gears.
You want to split
the hook up with other gears? And make those gears turn.
How do you feel about getting an appetizer?
Anyway, the bruschetta here is oddly good.
I'm a wings guy. Are you a wings girl? And I don't mean about the USA TV show.
Fried mac and cheese bites. I guess you don't care about your carbs, huh?
Someone's not worried about bikini season.
Why are you staring at me? Was I snoring with my eyes open again? It's been happening all day since I got nice.
You see that?
I got nicer earlier.
He goes, sorry if I'm coming down from my ring. by sunshine. You notice the rich bitch behind you? Grab her purse. We can split it. You ever chew and screw? We eat and then we run on the bill.
I guess called Dine and Dash when I was younger.
This is my dog that I have a jacket on. We live in Union Square.
I mean, I guess we could take an Uber XL back to my place. I can't fit you on my unicycle or I would.
I go on trains and tell people I need bus money. It's just for the dope.
I tell them that I have dope. They have to wait here while I go get it for my guy. And then I just hope they go away.
But they don't. They find you. And then they hit you in your sleep.
Oh, Jesus, that was Jason right there.
What are you talking about?
That squirrel just ran by you, he's mine. That's my squirrel.
I own him.
Yeah. He knows.
He knows he's
We're
mine.
We're inside, Jacob. We found out some awesome news.
I mean, immediately went to commercial, and Jacob tied up and pushed off and told us that.
Oh, yeah. Jacob's fucking in the world. He's in the stratosphere right now.
Yeah, Jacob booted, and then was like, as he's booting, he goes, by the way, your dad's still alive, and he lives in San Diego.
The killer woke before dawn. He put his boots on. He took a note from the ancient gallery, and he walked on down the hall.
Are you ready for a revolution, motherfuckers?
I am the...
Hi.
I'm the Shark King. I can do anything.
I swim, so I scare. Also,
this whole world is bullshit, you understand?
Black Lou's got a list.
It's not about corporations and selling ad reads. It's about the music, man.
Yeah, there's
It's about
stuff.
Touching souls and getting to a place
sure.
with people.
Sure, there's new shows, but you guys are the show.
Yeah, look, shows come. And do they have ad reads? Most certainly. But that's not the route, man. You guys aren't Valvoline Presents. The Bonfire, you guys are for the people, man. I want to see some love out there. You want to fuck? Fuck! I want to see some action out there! I want to see some action out there!
They can't
I
do
see
this!
Some action out there!
Heroin Jacob might be one of my favorite things.
Of all time. Jim Marsoning out.
Hey, don't worry about it, Lou. We could always whip the horse's eyes, right? Make them bleed.
I'm enjoying the Doors right now.
Goddamn yeah, right, John.
Yeah, you are.
You're That's the junk in your veins.
Oh, dude, we could go to a real. Yeah.
No, I appreciate it. There's a shark video.
I bet you, by the way, Jake would never be more happy if we just turned all the lights in the studio off. He's like,
oh, Mellow.
Deb comes
that
in.
That is sick, Mellow.
Deb comes in with her a back massage.
Oh, dude, hit all the lights off, Black Lou. Yeah. Oh, that. Well, that light flashing. No
safety. Seance in here.
It looks like such a Shark 70 shark video.
He goes, Mr. Shark.
Hi, Jacob. It's me, the shark.
Dan, I'll tell you, I found this hot little number one time.
Yeah.
Down in Lakewood.
Yeah.
And she was something, man. Hair flowing.
I'm the
in
truth.
The breeze.
I'm the truth, shark. You can be completely honest with me.
Can I tell you everything?
Everything.
And then. Anyway, long story short, Dan, this Indian girl looked through my soul and came out on the other end alive again. And, anybody else hungry?
Well, what Jacob did reveal to us before he pushed off was that...
There'll be no more... but you may feel a little sick.
I don't know if you know this, Jacob is a heroin addict now, so...
Yeah, Nikki, I think you just opened the door to a real problem.
Hey, everybody. Do you guys ever know that producing a radio show, years feel like minutes?
I'll tell you one thing. I should have been born in this motherfucking cowboy hat.
These two fucks think I'm joking around. Let them turn their backs on me. I'll flay him like a fucking fish. I done dirt. I'm a land shark.
And now the Bonfire Theater presents When Harry Met Sally.
It had to be you.
So, what do you do with these women? You just get up out of bed and leave?
Sure.
Well, explain to me how you do it. What do you say?
You'd say you have an early meeting, early haircut or squash game.
You don't play squash.
They don't know that. They just met me.
That's disgusting.
I know. I feel terrible.
You know, I'm so glad I never got involved with you. I just would have ended up being some woman. You had to get up out of bed and leave at 3 o'clock in the morning and clean your... What is that word?
And irons.
And you don't even have a fireplace. Not that I would notice.
Why are you getting so upset? This is not about you.
Yes, it is. You are a human affront to all women, and I am a woman.
Hey, I don't feel...
Wait, quick break. I feel like Christine's bullying Jacob here.
Cut.
You're putting nothing into the act. You're doing it like a person sitting in an audition room where she's just like yelping back the words at you. You act too. Poor Jacob, you're raking him over the coals here.
I was acting natural.
You're going, blah, blah, blah.
You know what?
Okay. Have a conversation.
We're co-directors here, like the Wachowskis brothers.
The sisters.
So I'm going to step in here and say, Jacob, I need just exactly what you're giving right now. Christine, little flowerier.
I need 90% out of you. I need 90 more percent out of you.
Okay, and you know what? I mean, he's a tough co-director, but I got to listen to him. All right, are we rolling?
Take
sound?
Take it back to two sentences.
Two sentences. Rolling sound. Speed.
And action.
Why?
Go ahead, Harry.
Why are you getting so upset? This is not about you.
Yes, it is. You are an affront to all women, and I am a woman.
Hey, I don't feel great about this, but I don't hear anyone complaining.
Of course. Not... Of course you're not. You're out of the door too fast.
I think they have an okay time.
How do you know?
What do you mean, how do I know? I know.
Because they...
Yes, because they...
And how do you know they really...
What are you saying? That they fake orgasm?
It's possible.
Get out of here.
Why? Most women at one time or another have faked it.
Well, they haven't faked it with me.
How do you know?
Because I know.
Oh, right. That's right. I forgot you're a man.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. It's just that all men are sure it never happened to them, and that most women at one time or another have done it. So, you do the math.
You don't think that I could tell the difference?
No.
Get out of here. Are you okay?
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, you're right there. Oh, there. Oh, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
I'll have what she's having.
Yeah! Yeah!
He ad-libbed the right there. That's not in the script.
He sold it. He bought into it.
Oh, that's Lower East Side.
I felt I got it at the end.
That must be the Strasburg technique.
Oh, that's Jake. That's Jake Patat. That is classic acting.
That was classic. You guys both did fantastic. How about everybody for Christine?
One more time. Christine and Jacob, Bonfire Theater. Didn't know you were into the Titanic as much as you are.
Yeah, no, I read a lot of books on the Titanic. I collect stuff.
You collect stuff. Do you have anything
that
was...
What do you collect, James Cameron?
Well, I got a rare book that came out. It's called The Sinking of the Titanic and Other Great Sea Tragedies. It came out a month after the Titanic sank because this guy was trying to capitalize on the sinking. So it was kind of like a money grab. But it's actually a really good book, and he interviewed a lot of people. It's a rare book, but I have that.
So you have that.
Yeah, that's the one.
Wow,
yeah.
All right. Sinking of the Titanic and Great Sea Disasters by Marshall Logan.
Yeah.
It looks like a child's book, Jacob.
It's $203 on biblio.com.
Yeah. Really?
You can get a first edition on Etsy for $95. I'm not trying to take the wind out of your sails there, Jacob.
What was it, on the Titanic or something?
They wrote it right after the Titanic sank.
The Titanic sank in April. It came out in May.
Is that guy in with the iceberg?
Really well done.
How did he know? Because back then it took him like 17 years to write a book.
Or to get information about the Titanic going down. Most people didn't even know.
He goes, I watched it. I watched it from the side and just took notes. So here are my notes. Do you want...
But I have my National Geographic.
Do you like the
Titanic
movie?
Titanic signed by James Cameron.
Do you like the movie?
Movie is very accurate. I love the movie.
It's very accurate.
Yeah. Very accurate.
Did People fell in love on a boat.
Did this movie get you into the Titanic, or did the Titanic get you into the movie?
No. See, I think the magic of the Titanic has kind of died down since the movie, but no, I was a huge fan because I was a teenager when the boat was found.
Oh, I thought you were going to say when the boat was finished, when the boat sank. I'm like, what are you, Wolverine?
Still too young to get on board, though.
I couldn't find
it. I saw those steam engines start pumping and chugga-chugga. Boy, oh boy, was I into it.
People take it for granted now, like your, you know, generations now just, they know where the ship is. But,
the king
man,
of the world.
That news broke September 1st or September 1985.
And they announced they found the Titanic.
Yeah.
And that just shook your shit up. What affected you more?
The first photo that came back was from the bow underwater. It was mind-blowing, yeah.
And you were like, and you were already into the Titanic, or did this get you into the Titanic?
This got me into it.
So this was like, oh,
I knew
shit.
About it like everyone else. It's just part of your...
Yeah, history.
History.
But you didn't know that they had... So when they found it, you're like, let me fucking get into this shit.
Yeah, and I got into it big time because, and then I researched... I love reading about... Airwolf, how they found it.
Oh man, perfectly. What affected you more, Airwolf being canceled or Titanic being found?
I don't know. By far the Titanic.
Really?
I didn't throw a tantrum. About anything.
Did you throw a
tantrum? I was excited. It was a good thing when I found the Titanic.
I was just thinking, did you throw a tantrum when you found out they were making a movie? Did it like make you mad?
No, I was actually excited.
Were you though? Because it's your shit. And you're like James Cameron, who's done some cool stuff, Aliens, Terminator.
I mean, but I my
Did you
one
start
of
looking
my favorite
Terminator,
like one of my maybe my favorite movie is Aliens. So when I read that it was James Cameron,
and he's super into Titanic. Did you know he was a Titanophobe? Is like you?
Titanophobe.
Yes. What do you guys call yourselves?
A Titanophiliac?
Philiac. A Titanic.
A Titaniac?
Yeah. Phobe's not the right word.
Most of the footage, he dove the Titanic. And so the footage in the movie is from the actual wreck.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
So when you.
He's actually
did
got
you see
some
it opening,
of the rarest footage.
Did you see it opening day?
No.
Did you dress like a person?
I saw it twice.
Yeah?
Did you write letters to Kate Winslet?
Be like.
I'll be your Jack.
Did you go to the front of a pontoon boat and scream, I'm the king of the world? I got a few more. Have you ever let a young man draw you naked?
I'm going to admit something very embarrassing.
Let it go.
This has nothing to do with my fascination of the ship.
Yeah.
You just kissed a guy once?
He goes, I kissed an Italian traveler.
I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the hole that I am... You know, fascinated with the history of the ship. I know the story of the, you know, Jack and Rose are the weak link, but every time at the end, I cry.
Oh, when they find each other in like Titanic heaven.
Right, yeah, when she has the dream
off the boat.
Yeah, when she's the old lady having her flashback and they meet up again on the ship.
Wow. One man's tearjerker is another woman's fucking finger blaster.
My
Niagara
man
Falls.
In heaven.
She's like, okay. Lock the goes, oh, here comes the dream part. Lock the door.
She goes, let me
turn
lay.
Up the music.
Let me lay with my hips a little up. Okay, here we go. I'm going to go see my Jack.
Oh, shit, okay.
Can I see my Jack?
Put your hands on me, Jack.
I will now. Oh, God. Oh, God.
You're trembling.
I'm beyond happy. I would never have gay sex behind your back either. It's the best show on TV now.
Is it? Hands
I'm telling
out.
You.
Why is that?
I mean, there's The Boys also.
Full frontal nudity?
Tell you what, Jay. See, mm-hmm. Flipper Flop is great because it's a show about transformation. They take this dilapidated house and they pump a bunch of money into it and they rebuild it, and it's incredible what they do. And then there's their relationship as a divorced couple. But Christina now got her own new show, Christine on the Coast, and she got married and she traded way up. Now
Wait,
she's
so
married
her new
to
husband.
Some English mechanic hunk that all the chicks love. Oh. I'm going to admit this. Well, let me say, Christina's specialty, I think, I love her backsplashes. When she does the kitchens.
What the fuck are you talking about?
We're talking about the actual work. Oh, I thought you meant when
guys come
show.
On her back.
Yeah, me too.
Getting those backsplashes.
She goes, splat-douche. Now
you
give
get
me a
back
towel.
Shots she followed goes, up by backsplashes.
Hey, Shamu, want to grab me a towel? You got me a little wet.
That's where your mind went.
Yeah.
It's
yeah,
all
yeah.
about the interior design.
So you like her
flip
backsplash.
Flip or flop, they'll put maybe 90, 100 grand into the entire house renovation.
Mm-hmm.
And Christina on the coast, she'll focus on one room. That's how it also differs from the other show. And so she'll put 90. They'll put 90 grand into the kitchen alone, and the backsplash.
Don't let Trish hear
spectacular
that. I can hear her getting wet all the way in Colorado.
Does it make you feel weird for having a Titanic poster on your wall?
I do. I mean, you know.
Yeah. Well, let's see.
But
do
let
we
me
have...
tell you, this is what I meant by bringing that up. Do you remember when that stripper? She was a stripper from 2 weeks ago, mm-hmm. Michelle Ryan.
Yeah,
porn star.
Adult entertainer.
Well, actually, we watched her clip,
mm-hmm.
and it was set in a kitchen, and I'm telling you, as she's sucking off her stepson, yeah. all I could think to myself the entire time
son.
Was, it's the
it was
worst backsplash I've ever seen.
You, really? That's what you noticed. You're like,
me out of the scene.
You're like, terrible backsplash.
If you see that scene now, and look at the backsplash,
can you bring up
you
Michelle Ryan blowing, can you bring up, it's adopted son, not
adopted
stepson.
Son.
It's adopted son.
It's a terrible backsplash, ruins the kitchen and ruined the reality of the scene for me.
All I was thinking about when I was talking about this is that the only person who would be more into this
is me.
Than me, I was going to say it would be Jacob. And then I started thinking in my head about post-apocalyptic Jacob, and it makes me laugh so hard.
I think I'd do well.
You would.
I'm more equipped than you are.
Whoa.
By far. I'm not insulting you. I'm just
no,
saying.
I'm
but
just
you,
saying I'm not proud of that. I have an extensive.
With your great body and just wearing like the football pads with skulls
goes,
on them.
He goes, part, move ways.
And the gang opens up.
Yeah. I knew him when the city stood. He's got, he was a friend.
I got knives covered.
Yeah.
He's got a gun with feathers that hang off of it and shit.
Great leader, what shall we do with him? He goes, hello, Jay.
Jacob?
Jacob?
People haven't called me that since computers ruined the world.
Sorry, my boys had to rough you up a little bit.
I am Farfanas. It's an old word meaning shark of the land.
Farfanas.
Farfanas. So join me. To eat salted meats and take one of my women as your bride.
I am the land shark.
Jay.
You will bow to me.
Sorry what happened to Dan back when New York fell.
I heard about Dan. Is family okay?
Did Trish make it out?
It's a shame.
It's a different world.
It was funny.
I like those voices.
Ain't no room for a funny, soft motherfucker out here, though.
I hope he's
playing. What are you doing, fat boy?
I hope he's playing Spider-Man in the sky.
And I think that's the heel turn.
Yeah.
He asks us,
shame. Dan was a good guy. Anyway, what brings your tubby ass out here, motherfucker?
You're looking for
you
food?
You want my rations?
You're looking for food to eat, fatso? All we have is human flesh. I'm a cannibal, motherfucker.
Well, you won't. You get hungry enough, you will.
Yeah. You know who I ate first? Whiskey. It was like a goddamn sausage. A Pollock sausage.
I'm going to stop when I'm dead.
Is it possible, Christine, to watch the video of this black woman with red hair?
Eve?
Red Gene Simmons come to her house.
Oh, you mean when Eve hung out with Gene Simmons?
It looks like Eve.
Jay, is that the most you've been watched three shows? You would say that's your max?
At one time?
Watched a show? Yeah. Definitely. If that's true, I'm so ashamed of myself.
How many do you got going
it's about,
on?
By the time when I get to start, I would watch five or six in a row. I end up falling asleep on like by the third. By the time
just
I start
watching.
What is Jacob?
That's a lot, Jacob. What's going on now?
What's going on?
What are you telling us?
Are you like Christian Bale in The Mechanic? What was that movie where he gets all fucking
skinny?
I'm ashamed.
The Machinist.
Say what I'm about to say.
Say it.
I blew through two seasons of The 100 last weekend. I got
how many episodes is that?
What? 12.
24 episodes.
I don't
in 48
know.
Hours.
Yeah, but Jay,
in 48
in my,
hours,
in
you
my
watched
defense,
24 of them?
In my defense, that's 42 minutes apiece. Just not a full hour.
All right. It's not Olympic time.
Oh.
So you're not an HBO hour.
There was time in between to look around at how lonely you were being.
Great show.
Anybody want to stop me from doing this next episode? Say aye or I move forward.
Hands up if you want to watch another app.
Yep, that's all right. It. Majority
it's
rule.
It's unanimous.
Time to watch it.
Couch, what are you? He starts talking to his shit like Pee-wee.
Good night, Moon. Good night, Couch.
Good night, Silverware.
It was getting dark.
Dude, that's the worst.
I was so ashamed of myself.
Take a shower?
I went to the gym. But you're not wrong when there are times I'm watching the show and I feel I gotta be productive, so I'll do the crunches on the exercise ball while I'm watching the show just to feel like I'm doing
you're just talking about the morning of Dexter and American Psycho.
Yeah,
by the way,
if you were super into business cards, I'd be really worried about you.
I make steak and eggs. I tie my shoelaces. I have to make sure they're the same length. Then I tie them.
Then I tie them slowly.
It's all intricate.
Because then,
all
you know,
together.
When a woman dies, she doesn't know she's going to die until it's just a little too late.
When you sever the head, they say the brain function lasts for about another 54 seconds.
Do you like Huey Lewis in the News? Their first album, Sports, came out in 1983. Their follow-up, which some critics panned.
Four.
Jacob.
You're
doing
too much.
It's not too much. People that go all through the night. I was hammered.
No, I've done that.
Okay, Jacob. Give me some ground to stand on here. I'm trying to defend you.
I mean, I think I watched one till 5 in the morning, and then I conked out. It's only
weird if you have the people who deliver food. If you yell, "Doors open," you make them bring it right to you on the couch. And he goes,
yeah, sure. That's what you do, right? But what are you paying for?
You mess yourself.
I'll get it myself. I'm going to go out.
Sunday nights are for cleaning up your mess from the weekend, and you poop and piss all over yourself.
He's like, oh, I got to go put this delivery guy in the boric acid tub.
Okay, why do you, what?
I have to melt the body of this delivery guy, Dan.
He saw my life.
He found the map. The map to what, Jacob?
We can't have this conversation.
That's, but I mean,
I don't want to hurt you, Dan.
What, have you watched a whole season in one sitting? Yeah, it's a yes. That is a yes. Jacob, is that a yes?
No.
You put a muzzle on a brand new zombie, they're fuckable for a couple hours.
Hell, I'll tell you this right now. You make sure they don't bite you, you can tit fuck a zombie all day.
What's your zombie rule? I'll tell you what.
Tit fuck, TF all day.
If you're a necrophiliac, it's gotta be a little bit better.
That's Christmas and your birthday.
You get to fuck a dead person and they're moving for you a little bit?
Yeah, moving and grooving. Or maybe that's their thing. Maybe necrophiliacs like the whole... Do you think when necrophiliacs...
Okay, before you ask, I just wanted to say, Jake, I see you throwing face... I'm not saying to fuck a dead, well, you know, you only have a few hours. Like a brand new dead zombie. You're rolling your eyes. This guy's better than fucking a fucking brand new zombie.
Not one that's deteriorated.
It's brand new.
You gotta wear shirts with holes in them.
How deteriorated? Yeah. Come on, man.
Come on. Just see a girl, like a nice thick zombie going by.
Thick ass zombie, but brand new.
Brand, like right off the boat.
Like OD'd in the locker room of a strip club.
She just walked out. She's finding her way out to the light.
Just walked out.
And by the way, you got
fresh wax.
You got a fuck muzzle on you. You throw it on her.
Yeah, you got a fuck muzzle.
Yeah, you put that on.
You put the bit in her mouth.
Yeah, you put down. You got your condom on. You got your Jimmy hat on.
I gotta tap out.
Yes, throw your gym hat.
It's lit.
You bang it up. You're ready to go. Yeah.
Throw on your Jimmy hat.
Yes.
That's the funny thing to say as you're biting a package of them. You just finish muzzling your zombie and stretching your legs open. You go,
just throwing a strap. Better strap up my gym hat. Have you met my friend Jim Hat?
He goes, better grab my bag. He goes, so anyways,
he's looking at his dick. He's
I'm a knife guy. I'm not a scientist. I don't know how this shit works.
He goes, you probably had this sooner than I did. Here we go. You ready to party?
And
let me line it up.
And
we're in.
There we go. Still warm?
Oh, hey.
Still warmer than I thought.
Yeah, see?
Warmer than I thought.
Meh. Meh.
Meh. Meh. Somewhere, meh. Someone listening right now.
Meh.
Meh. Someone listening right now, driving their car, is really like batting around the idea of, do they write a letter? Like, how do they complain about this? What we're doing right now, exactly. What he's doing right here to a human being is abysmal. It's a horrific, horrific thing he's doing. But
we're talking zombie apocalypse.
To a made-up zombie, it's what? Fine.
I don't mean... You're getting a hole.
If listen, that zombie would kill you
eat your
if
face.
You didn't rape it.
Eat your face.
Think.
And you don't know what the laws of consensual sex are with zombies.
I couldn't.
I don't. What nope. zombie law, even?
We have to go to Haiti to figure that out.
They haven't
consent
evolved that far.
Consent is consent with me.
What?
If I would have to get a zombie consent.
You
to
yeah.
Excuse me. I noticed you just stumbled out of cheetahs. I was wondering if you'd want to have sex. Brains. Yeah, brains? Say brains again if you mean yes.
Brains.
Growl if you want this dick. Come chase me.
All right,
me.
Baby girl. You don't got to ask this boy.
Stop pursuing me.
She goes to rip his shirt off.
All right. Chill, babe. Damn, girl.
Just going to grab you here. Fuck yeah. Muzzle you.
There you go. It goes over and around and on the crown.
That's a Windsor knot. I'm an idiot.
I almost got my dick bit off.
There's so many diseases carried through cum. Like, I don't know. Is she saying that she refrigerates it first?
Yeah.
Jacob's twirling up a fucking hunk of spaghetti. He goes, this is fantastic pink sauce. How do you make it? She goes, to make a sauce in cum.
Her boyfriend doesn't have syphilis. What if he cheated on her?
Jacob, I don't know what happened to you. But I don't even know if she has a boyfriend, Jacob.
Why do you think
you're
it's a
hung
boyfriend?
Up on this.
Which means that when my boyfriend does drop semen to me,
she just said,
"What
didn't
girl made you drink her boyfriend's cum, Jacob?"
Said
what did it happen?
She said
they leave it on the doorstep. She didn't say her boyfriend.
Oh my
Who's
god!
Who's leaving it on the doorstep?
Strong men with strong semen.
You think her boyfriend goes and leaves? She goes, I like to pretend it's like a milk delivery. So my boyfriend goes out and puts it on the step. He does.
That's what I said, Jay. She gets it on the doorstep.
No, I know he gets it on the doorstep, but I'm saying Jacob keeps, he's consumed with her having a boyfriend.
My boyfriend does drop semen to me.
Jacob.
You know what? Jacob.
Jacob, hold on, guys. Guys.
Telling me random guys is even worse. So can
guys, hold on.
Anything in those loads.
Guys, I know how to explain this. I just recently had to explain something to my little cousin. This will work with Jacob. Jacob, there's a cum stork that brings cum to mommies that need cum for their smoothies.
Cum stork.
I'm glad you think that multiple random dudes loads is safer than the boyfriend.
Jacob, I don't think it's safer.
Drink up, boys. Drink
Jacob,
up.
Jacob,
take
I don't
a
get.
Shot, Jay.
I don't pick behind.
Love it so much.
I don't get behind. I don't get behind.
Drink a cum shake. You love it so much.
No.
I get behind. I'm not into cum shakes, Jacob. I never have been. I'm just saying you seem to be. You keep saying a situation that's not happening. It's making me think a woman's made you drink her boyfriend's cum in order to fuck her, and then she didn't fuck you afterwards, and you have been really holding a grudge about that. She goes, I'm just kidding. I just want to see if you drink Daryl's cum. Daryl, come out of the closet. You got that.
Ha ha. Ha ha, you little pussy. You drank my cum.
You drank my cum, you fucking wiener.
You homo slut.
You're a rock and roll comic. Drink the shake.
Jacob.
Get up. You're so cool.
It's not about
it. I can't breathe. Oh my God.
You live such a wild life for me. Drink it up.
Jacob's irritated.
You drink it up. Drink it up is the new Jacob slogan.
You love cum, drink it up.
There's your first limited edition shirt. Drink it up, Jacob.
Drink it up, dude.
You love it so much, drink it up. Just a picture of a fucking smoothie.
Oh, God, dude. God.
It should be a picture of a smoothie with a smiling sperm in it. It says, you love it so much.
God damn it, dude. I haven't laughed that hard in so fucking long. My God, my fucking organs hurt.
I'm going to leave Jacob alone. He went on the attack.
No, dude, I get it.
Sorry. I'm sorry you drank that dude's cum that one time, Jacob. It wasn't me who did it to you. You could have given us a warning to not bring things like this up.
I'm the nerd. I live a sheltered life. You drink it up, bad boy.
Who's saying they're drinking cum, Jacob?
Oh, fuck.
Jacob fell in love with a girl. Horrific service, fantastic body in Austin, Texas. At the Where? Bikinis bar when we were watching the game.
Oh, yeah. Oh dude, that chick would have...
She was a good person, too.
No, she was. She would have ruined... Jacob fell in love with her and tried telling me her life
she
story.
She tells the best story. And super funny.
I go, first off, that's my book, Jay. Quit stealing my playbook. But I told Jacob, she would walk by and he'd go,
nah, she would get it all. She'd understand the shipwrecks and the NASCAR.
I go, dude, she would ruin your life.
She loves artifacts.
She would fucking ruin you, dude.
She would cook for me when I'm sick.
No, yeah. She wouldn't. No, she wouldn't. You don't think her ex-boyfriend... She'd be like Sharon Stone in Casino.
You don't know.
Yeah,
you.
I do. Yeah, I do. You. I know.
You think you know people. You don't.
Yeah. Dude, the best was she would be. You guys would get married, and you'd have this extravagant Jewish wedding, and then she'd be on the phone with her ex-boyfriend crying, and he'd go, "I'm right there, and I'm looking at you."
When I met you, my heart did a kip up.
Yeah.
Oh God, Chantel.
Her name would be like Natasha.
Natasha, when I met you at Bikinis, you looked at me, and I saw an angel. I knew that I was no longer alone.
Oh, dude, she would
take
walk.
My hand in the proverbial lobby of the Titanic.
You can find love at Bikinis.
Look at Sex Island.
Jacob,
these
come on.
These are not the girls.
Yum, yum,
yes,
yum.
They are.
Gonna get there and
when you pour champagne.
A whole different level.
Oh, man. God, that is.
Jacob, but
they're not
but
even hot. These girls Jacob, aren't even hot to me.
I'm so vanilla that I'm really enjoying it.
Jacob,
this.
Even if you don't go fuck, it's not like you spent all that money and you didn't fuck. We're sending you there. I think this is a good idea.
I think it's a great idea. Vote for it. Should we send Jacob to Sex Island? Let's do a poll on Twitter.
Save your breath. It's going to be... This poll might be...
100%?
100% he should go. And then a few people, like, you know, maybe
yeah,
a
there's
couple...
moral obligations.
No, I just think a few girls might be like, leave Jacob alone type thing. But it's like...
Why? We're trying to get him laid.
Yeah, I mean, oh, I'm sorry. I was like, hey, leave Jacob alone. So I'm offering him this $5,000 vacation.
To Fuck Island.
To Fuck Island.
Oh God.
Yeah.
This oh God.
Yeah. Just release. Oh. Let it go.
This oh, is Gloria.
Let it go. Release all over her.
This is Gloria. We consider her the Velociraptor of Sex Island.
Yes.
She's smart. Can open doors.
Jacob, these chicks in this video are pretty fucking hot.
Yeah, I mean the one on the left. I'm loving this. I am in so vanilla Dan mode.
Girls that are gonna. I don't find them hot, and these are not the girls that you're going to see when you get there.
You don't
Jacob,
find
you don't
them
find
hot.
Them hot, Jacob. I mean, come
honestly,
on, Jacob.
Jacob, you're not into this at all. Jacob,
you say these girls on this are not hot girls.
But, Jacob, you're tightening up. I can feel your producer-ness. You're tightening up now because you know it's getting close to it's going to happen.
I'm my type.
Jacob, what does that mean?
Your type.
I'm not in the blondes, really. But if you fucking put blonde hair on all these chicks, I still go, yeah, they're all fucking hot chicks.
Jacob, look at the girl on the left. She's incredibly hot.
How about just the girl behind him like, with the sunglasses on?
Look at the dude.
The girl there.
Look at the body
of
the
fucking dude.
Is
that guy gonna be there?
Jacob, I think you're starting to tighten up because you know we're serious about this.
Yeah, I know you. No, I believe you. But I don't have it in me to go to Sex Island.
So you want to stand? You want
please? I
so as
that.
So as it stands, you don't want your argument is you don't want to go fuck super hot chicks for free.
Jacob, we got to take a break. But when we come back, Jacob got a flyer that he was like trying to push on me.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we should read it.
He was trying to get you
to read this flyer.
On the air?
Yeah. No, just in life. And I was like, no, you're going to bring it in.
Somebody's trying to sell to you in some way?
Yeah.
Is Jacob trying to get you to buy?
Timeshare.
Is he trying to get you to buy M&Ms for he can buy jerseys for his basketball team?
Hey, everybody, I've got a basketball team and we're raising money.
No, you're trying to give me a timeshare.
I'm a good kid doing a good thing. I'm trying to stay out of jail. I could be on the streets robbing people, but I'm here on the train. Trying to earn a living doing the right thing.
Yeah, no, he tried getting
who me wants to- some Welch's gummies.
I thought it was going to be a timeshare in Miami.
Yeah.
Hey, Dan, you're doing pretty well when you're not filming Billions. Do you like to relax? Do you like the smell of the ocean?
Do you enjoy humidity that makes your bones hurt?
What if you... Do you like old people that look like they're always about to fall down?
Do you like Cuban coke lords and elderly people and nothing in between?
And nothing. And then just raw, aggressive nature in the form of swamps?
Dan, have you ever dreamed of living on a fan boat? Well, have I got a flyer for you.
Hi, I'm Jacob. I'm Everglades Jacob. Some people say the Everglades can't provide...
Everglades Jacob is my favorite thing ever. Yeah. Hey, it's me, Everglades Jacob, here again with another gator tip. Everyone, if a man extends his arm in front of your face, you chop it and you death roll.
Hey, everybody, I'm Everglades Jacob. A lot of questions we get here are, what are the differences between an alligator and a crocodile? All the difference in the world.
You're not going to do it?
No, not now.
Why?
You were going to do
no,
it.
No, I wasn't going to do
it. You were going to do it.
No, I wanted were you guys to do see it? It. No, I wasn't. I don't believe it.
I think you could. I think you want to
Can you
do
make
it.
Me a woman weird science style?
Hey, Teresa, it's Jacob again. Sorry to bother you.
It was uncomfortable.
I was wondering if you could bump me up to 5'10".
Well, I broke another hooker, Teresa.
Teresa.
What do I do?
She touched my neck, and you know that just sets me off.
None of their heads turn all the way around the way I asked for.
Like Mommy promised when I was in the broom closet.
I took the pamphlet for the show, but you do feel like kind of a jerk off taking it, because you're on the subway and then everyone's kind of looking
at
you.
What was she like?
What was she wearing?
No. What, Teresa?
Did you meet Teresa?
No. These were just, they're just scattered all over in the subway.
Oh, they weren't her. I thought maybe her minions even came up to you.
Oh, Teresa.
I was like you once, and then I found Teresa.
How you doing? My name is Rick. I am from Orange, New Jersey. I met Teresa, and she set things right. I'm now the COO of a Fortune 500 company. My wife is my best friend, and all my children have perfect teeth.
I was going to go the opposite with it. He goes, I was working in finance, making $200K a year, doing pretty well for myself. Teresa showed me that my real dream of being a fan boat captain.
Yeah. I thought that...
Oh, boy, that's what I want to do. Oh,
you have created a lot of money for yourself, but how much do you miss catching bugs?
Should I catch bugs?
You need to catch bugs.
Have you ever seen the Glades on a fan boat?
Now, most boats, they use paddles or engines. But what about a giant fan?
Jacob, you were gone forever.
You were in Florida.
Yeah, to get time.
Bat hunting, or what was it? You were doing something crazy?
I'm spelunking for gold.
I did a lot of diving. I did my
did
first
you?
Night dive.
Did a night dive?
Yeah.
How terrible. You're.
It was terrifying.
So let me ask you this, but Jacob, because you're a fan of sharks, but you seem to want to court danger with them a lot.
Well, that's why I do it, because I'm trying to get over my fear. But
hey, is that really?
Yeah.
What are you fags looking at?
I heard if I punch you in the nose, you bitches swim right off.
What's up, doll eyes?
Shark? More like octopussy. Get out of here.
The scariest thing is when you're before you go under, because it's just, it's night.
Yeah.
In the middle of nowhere. They take you out far from land, right?
Well, I did it off the...
Dock.
Off the dock.
Oh, really? I guess it's still pretty scary.
I mean, there's sharks everywhere.
It's
Are there sharks off the dock?
Yeah, I mean, where I
Or did
dive,
they lie?
Like
Was the diver
white...
like, oh no, you're going to a real dangerous place?
You dive in great white country?
There's great whites everywhere, but yeah, the places I've dove, there have been like great whites.
I didn't like that.
By like a week.
I didn't like, it's very unlikable, Jacob, to be so passive-aggressive about that.
Can I tell you also?
There's great whites everywhere.
He just shit on you with his shark knowledge.
Jesus. You feel the fucking venom coming off? I go, is it shark country? Is it great whites out where you're doing? He goes, there's great whites everywhere.
I mean, the ocean's 75% of the earth. set them up for tot. That was perfect. Me and my buddy call you land dwellers.
Oh, my God. I almost sent you a picture. I saw, man, the right by my house has a Futuro section. I mean, it's just nonstop wristbands.
Really?
Oh.
I mean, do you need a new one? Can we buy you a new one?
I've got two Futuros. They capitalize all the drugstores in the city.
They do. Yeah, they must have a deal with Dwayne Reed or CVS.
I've got a travel Futuro and a home Futuro.
Hell yes.
You Futuro-ass motherfucker.
You have a travel CPAP machine. Jacob goes with a bunch of different things.
I can't leave without my travel humidifier!
He brought all of his scuba gear from here. Flippers. That's a CO2 tank.
Because that thing, it takes me about 6 hours to get through security, but it's worth it.
Night dive. Did you see one of those fish with the bulb on his head?
He wasn't going to the fucking cross. He wasn't going to the bottom of the earth.
Oh, I thought you were doing archaeology work. I thought in your spare time you Indiana Jones the world.
No, he looked at a bunch of empty beer bottles at the bottom of a dock.
Time to go traverse uncharted territory, everyone.
I wonder what it'll be like to come out in China.
What'd you do for New Year's Eve?
My laundry.
Party animal.
Yeah.
Party fucking animal.
I'm surprised we didn't find you in a fucking pile full of bounty sheets.
Oh, man.
You're living...
Wash and fold. Wash and fold. I'm hopped up.
I had the place all to myself.
Ooh, living fast and loose, baton.
You got a roommate?
No.
Oh, you said that place all to yourself. I didn't know.
The laundryman.
I suspect you had laundry in your house.
Did you start doing a song and dance combo in the laundromat to dance in your new year?
put a little liquid fabric softener on the floor and slide around.
He goes, oh no, looks like we're taking in 2018 and in the coolest way possible. Dance segment! Just take those old records off the shelf. It says all, because you got to give your all. Ah! I sit and listen to them by myself.
I mean, I did the same thing, Jacob. I didn't do shit for New Year's. Because the guy just gave me a look, and I was like, man, what the fuck?
Motherfucker.
Like, but just like,
we're never going to find this out.
We'll just move.
Oh, wait. Oh. Maybe this might be it.
Hey, watch out, Jacob.
No. Fucking faggot.
Whoa. Jacob,
come on, man.
That wasn't him.
We know our buddy Jacob is recouping still, although this is a lost tape, so if not, we're so sorry to hear about the loss of Jacob Batat.
His shark tooth will be on sale on the Bonfire website.
Shark tooth. We will be having a fire sale for Jacob's apartment.
Jacob's angel. Hi. Look, I'm up in heaven, guys. Don't worry. All the Titanic's here. Even Jack and Rose.
Do you think...
I'm always going to be here.
Right in here. Guys, don't talk about Fugelsang.
And then when you die, you will come join me in the kingdom of Titanic.
Oh, man, what if you die, Lou, and Jacob's there to grab your hand at the top of the staircase?
In the kingdom.
So you go to this woman's house.
Yeah. Now it's night. It's nighttime. We're on our couch, and then she actually has a door to a little... backyard that has a canal, so we just talked around there.
Oh, you guys are outside.
Then we went back in.
What music was playing again?
I said, put on something nice.
Did
soft,
you say
not too crazy? You
did
know?
You say? Did you say? Oh, that wasn't the canal I was hoping to see.
She went. Excuse me. Did you just call my pussy a canal?
Yeah.
He went.
Yeah, I did.
Confident Jacob?
Yeah, he goes,
so what if I did?
Yeah, he goes,
what of it?
She goes, I don't know, just wondering why you haven't been over here and all up in it.
Hey, do me a favor, I get this complaint a lot. Would you tell me, is this too big for my size?
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. You're waking him up. Wait, wake him up. You're going to wake him up.
Look, he smells food.
You want to give him a mouse? You want to give him a mouse?
Huge cock, Jacob. Yes. Uh-oh.
Oh, look who's here. Look who's here.
Oh.
Oh, there must be a swami playing a flute somewhere, because the cobra just woke up.
Uh-oh. Is that thick?
You think you can handle that girth?
Yeah.
You think you can handle it?
Because you meditate? Might need some of those breathing exercises.
You do your Kegels this week? Because you're going to have a hard time.
Yeah. I don't know if we can put you back together.
What time you have to wake up tomorrow? 6? I'll go half speed.
Bad hips? Just need to check. You got a heart condition? Bad hips?
You mind signing this for me?
You go to Six Flags? Can you ride their coasters? All right, you're good.
25 years of operation. Only lost 2 people.
Jacob, you can buy rolling iTunes! Over in his grave.
Oh.
Come on, guys.
Can you hear?
He's going to have to go down to the subway and have that guy teach him how to move a piece of paper in here or something.
He goes, get off my train. He goes, I would rather be on a boat.
If Jacob does die, we have to put him out to sea in one of those things we found.
Oh, hell yeah.
You know, the little shark that you get inside?
He goes, let me swim with my school. Let me go back. Let me go back to the way it was.
DJ Lewis.
When I was a shark! When were we doing that?
The foxhole crew.
Dude, now we have a cheese slicing set?
Wine and cheese.
Fucking cheese.
1221 Avenue of the Americas.
1221
437.
Series XM. Attention, Jacob.
New York, New York, 10020.
10020. And
yeah, good job, Jacob.
For all your cheese fantasies.
Hey, it's Jacob, can you give me directions and trail off the most important part? Goes,
you're going to go up 2 blocks, make a right, and before you know it, you'll be
if you want to disarm the bomb, you first have to separate the levers, and then you just cut.
green wire.
Do you cut the green wire?
I trailed off because I don't remember the
zip code ever. Well, you have to cut the green wire first, and then
make sure
you can't touch the red wire and then the blue wire.
If you trip the white wire next to the blue wire. I'm actively trying to
touch the white wire.
I love Jacob Bomb Squad more than I like.
Do not touch the white wire.
You take the make sure you get the pliers and then you cut.
I'm actively trying
it
to find
it is imperative that you unhook the thing.
If you see the fluid start to mix on it, you
I think we're calling on all of our diehard 3 bomb information. If the fluid starts to mix.
By the way, I really did kill all the fun because I knocked an entire coffee into the carpet.
Can I say this right now? Jacob's walking back in. He is pissed.
Oh, my God. He does push-ups on that floor, Lewis.
Dude, look at that. I mean, dude, it was an entire full cup of coffee that I went and got 10 minutes ago.
Was it while you were dancing?
Yeah.
Oh, it's the worst. It goes from fun to horrible in a heartbeat.
You should have seen
everything. Oh, my God. It looks like there's more coffee than would fit in that cup.
Let me see.
It looks like they asked if you want room for milk, and you said, nah, fill it to the brim.
Well, here's what I'm going to kick this thing over.
I was letting it cool. I was like, oh, I'm not going to drink this coffee until it's a little bit cooler. And
oh, that's hot coffee.
Dude, my favorite thing was like Jacob talking through his teeth, where I'm like, Jacob, don't worry. Let it soak in. He's like,
no, it's okay.
No, no, Jacob also tried to clean it up with a wet nap. One single wet nap.
It's all I had.
I feel like there's a good nemesis brewing between Lewis and Jacob.
Also, to Jacob.
A rivalry.
To Jacob, that was like a fucking bath sheet. You have to understand, a wet one.
Yeah. He does have a tiny, tiny waist. Oh, yeah, but he's so
in great
powerful.
Shape, dude.
Dude, yeah. You don't understand. He is, I want to say, 4% body fat. Am I wrong?
I have no idea.
Oh, stop.
Just, you know, Lewis, Jacob, he's very quiet. He'll light your shit up. He
dude, seriously. I swear to God.
He is holding back from uncorking the ass beating of a lifetime.
I'm going
to
throw another coffee
at
the ground. No. Now there's a thick tension in the air between DJ Shark Wolf and DJ Lewitsky.
I would like to bring something up.
What would you like to bring up?
I do welcome Lou back. Although I do have something that I feel is important, and I need to bring the both of you in.
Okay.
It involves pride. You write scripts, Dan, right?
Yeah, they never get made. But,
all right, but would you hand one in with grammatical errors?
No.
Now, you would take pride. It would be embarrassing to you.
Yeah, absolutely. I feel stupid.
I want to talk about Lou's spelling of the PDT, the title, the radio titles.
What is that?
Terrific. It's what we title our segments.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Black Lou or white Lou?
It's mainly you. I've actually corrected Lou in the past. He hasn't made a mistake in a long time.
Who, LJ?
Yeah, that's been a
Sean
while.
Fury. That's what Sean Fury calls him. That's what we call him now.
LJ.
Not Black Lou.
Lou, how do you spell gigolos?
I don't give a flying fuck.
This is what I'm talking about.
Jacob, suck my cock.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck.
Here's his radio.
Let's go. Pearl Jam.
Radio.
Ever seen Pearl Jam?
He's jammed up.
Yeah, fuck you, bro. Don't come at me with your stupid fucking
Who cares
edicts.
About pride, right? In the show.
How do you spell suck my dick?
I know how to spell it.
You know what? You two got a lot of tension, and this has been boiling up for a while, so I'm glad we're finally at this point, because I think we can help.
According to Lou, I'm sorry to cut you off, gigolos is spelled J... I-G-G-L-A-L-O-S.
Well, in fairness, he did spell jiggle O's.
Yeah. I mean, he did. Phonetically, he nailed it.
That was like a week ago. You've been sitting on this fucking caper for a long time.
I can't always miss it. I can't always catch it.
I knew it started with a G. I may have even thrown an extra G in the middle, though.
I would have definitely thrown an extra G.
I may have made a giggle O's.
Giggle O's. I definitely would have made a gigolos.
And also, I think Lou...
Gigolos.
Got any more brain busters?
How about one of my all-time favorites? When you were talking about the difference between Waffle House versus Denies.
Oh, Denny's.
Only one. Why put two N's when you can only save the space?
Now wait a second.
You are
now,
a spiteful what, little man.
Here's
aren't
what.
You?
Here's what I don't know if we're understanding, and this does make it funnier. I think I understand what you're saying now. When someone's listening to this on the radio,
you're seeing this
and the segments come up.
That's what aired all last week.
I mean,
all
right.
You know what?
That does make it a little bit different.
Jay, you take Jacob's side all you want. I'm going to take Lou's side because you spell words like a cool kid.
Thanks, man. I didn't spell
cool
that.
Cool kid spelling.
Spell
he spells
thing.
It the Lou Witzky way. Like, truth is now T-R-U-F.
So hopefully no one's... Jacob's saying, though, what if somebody wants to search for a segment
yeah,
online, and they can't because they don't know how to spell retard.
I didn't spell that Denny's, by the way, Jacob. That's wait, that's BLS.
LJ?
Yeah, that's LJ. Sorry.
Buddy, I don't know if you know this, but LJ's got a guy in his corner that almost knocked out Mike Tyson and wrote Thriller.
Yeah, dude. I don't really know if you want to bark up that tree.
I'm not going to give you that one because that was, I caught that one, and that was Black Lou. But I caught that before.
But you're really starting a war with the lose,
but
Jacob.
Jiggle O.
LJ, you're not going to like what's going on in here.
I didn't shoot up. In fact, I complimented him.
You did compliment. He complimented.
I did compliment.
But he's going after the lose pretty hard. Christine,
I don't think it's a big deal. I just feel like, because I have brought it up off the air, and Lou told me, suck my dick.
Well, he did it on air, too.
And then he said, my favorite, I'm a radio guy. I'm not a speller. Yeah. Something like all that.
Right. He feels the music. I do audio. He doesn't have to read it.
I do audio guy.
I'm a radio guy. I'm not a speller. Is not a great quote.
Why is he in charge of
well,
spelling?
I take that back.
He loads.
It's a fantastic quote, but it's nonsensical to say the least.
It does sound like the rantings of a crazy person.
Can I compliment Lou also? I do think I've said this to anyone.
His job's easy.
No,
yeah.
He's the,
I thought that's what you said.
He's the greatest board op, not on in this country in the world.
Absolutely,
100%.
Yes,
yeah,
100%.
Yes,
I respect you a lot. Exactly.
I mean, that's just lightning fast. He just turned Jacob on Jacob. If Bert was here, he would have had an aneurysm.
Bert's head would have exploded.
Let me tell you right now what Bert loves. Jacob on Jacob.
I mean, Bert really loves
Joe Rogan on Joe Rogan.
We're talking to Joe Rogan.
That was fantastic.
Yeah. He loved it far more than I loved it.
Yeah,
I did love when they did the shaved ape. The shaved ape talk.
Oh, it was unbelievable. That's
hilarious.
But here's the, that was so well done. That was so fucking well done.
It's amazing.
Well, yeah. Anyways, Jacob, back to you.
Well, he did call, though. He said play 20 seconds and stuff.
Am I trash?
I mean, no, keep shitting on the lose. I'm just here defending
him. I only have one more. It's not
Black Lou and White Lou, LJ and Witsky.
All right, so you found two spelling mistakes, one by White Lou, one by Black Lou.
I did not.
Is the other one
no,
say,
I'm talking
is it called
to you.
Like the Bonfire, Bonfire?
What if it was like Bonfire PH instead of
yeah, Bonfire?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I thought we
the
were
PDT.
Hip.
They're
cool kid spelling.
Now he's trying to turn me turn you on me because even though I complimented you when you were out of the room.
Black Lou, he wasn't complimenting you.
He did compliment
which
you.
Which PDT? Which PDT?
Blackwell,
I just want to say this to your face. He called you three-fifths of a person. It was hard to listen to. A lot of us are real struggling with it.
Here's another thing.
He said he's down with voter suppression. I don't know.
He said
you wrote Funniest Show on Earth.
Yeah, he said in one of the interviews you wanted to ask them a question.
Yeah.
So we didn't know.
He said when you put out there, today we celebrate Jacob's birthday.
Yeah.
And that just...
And then Jacob...
It left a bad taste.
And then he burned a pair of Nikes. It was pretty aggressive.
I'm not a good speller, but my first thing would be to spell check because I know I'm not even good.
Well, here's
with Lou, I feel it's this.
So you use pride. Lou, this is where you mean pride the other way.
With Lou, no, but here's the thing. I don't think Lou doesn't have pride. I think it's pure confidence.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think he just thinks there's no way this
he's
can be
cocky.
Wrong.
He's adopted the whole fell dog demeanor.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he's from right outside Teaneck, New Jersey.
And apostrophes? If I ask them to do that, it's like I'm from the Hamptons, like a summer in the Hamptons. Who does apostrophes?
You think people are uppity if they use punctuation?
Dude, he goes, ain't no punctuation higher than me. Why is a punctuation going to be up above the word?
Lou, how do you talk? You just keep
shitting.
Saying everything you're thinking until
now
it's
that's
completely
both
done?
Of them. I'm going to say both of them have I've caught apostrophe mistakes.
Okay.
I'm not that's even, but
one more strike
I try to catch
lose.
It.
Tell me he used a semicolon and it was wrong. I'll kick him in the face from where I sit.
I'll throw him out that window. I'll fit him through that tiny window out in the hallway.
But one time, if I got to bring up a quote, it was Lou's brother's girlfriend.
Will?
Stu.
That was the title of the segment.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes I have break
no
kayfabe.
Apostrophe on either.
Wait, what did it say?
Lou's brother's girlfriend.
So it was multiple. So what? Maybe it was multiple Lou's and multiple brothers and multiple girlfriends.
L-O-U-S.
Wait.
It is not even.
No possessive.
No apostrophe.
No.
No.
That doesn't sound like me.
Yeah.
You saying, now you're saying it's Black Lou. Now the loser.
I don't know which one that was.
Is that
Black Lou? I can't even recall.
I'm still trying to catch up here. Was it a PDT?
Yes, from last night. Yeah, we're talking PDT all day in here, dude.
No.
From a while ago.
You're listening to some straight PDT.
I didn't even have one on you for a while. This was Lou's from last week, Thursday show.
I love Jacob. Tried to do it behind the scenes and it didn't work, so he brought it to the air.
You just see an end of. Jacob, let me say something.
Because it's up to you now. It's out of my. Obviously, I have no pull. It's only, you know.
Jacob, hold on. Let me say something. I've been giving, you know, everyone's got secondary nicknames now, whether it be Black Lou's secondary nickname is.
You see Isabella's, the pass, you what the pass to say when Lou puts you on security?
What?
Show him. It's great. It's fantastic. How hilarious that's
Black Lou Johnson.
Black Lou Johnson.
That is great.
It's fantastic.
I mean, his.
Your name's in his Black Lou?
I can put whatever I want.
No, that's fucking great. Well, the point is that Black Lou was dubbed by Sean Fury, LJ, that's his secondary nickname. DJ Lou, his secondary nickname is White Lou or Witsky, Lou Witsky.
Oh, I call him DJ No Apostrophes.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to start calling Jacob the Professor. Because I feel like you got a real professor vibe right
professor
now.
Professor Grammar?
Yeah, you're breaking down the PDTs.
Look, if it's okay with you...
Well, here's the thing. Now, what you've done is a really fun thing.
I thought you cared.
How about this? Though? Should we offer?
Hand in the script to FX with no grammar, no misspelling. See how far you get.
Listen, Belding, we have fun in here. Well, what were you saying, Jay?
What would you like me to? What would you prefer?
Why don't we make it now a fun thing that if the campers catch it.
Yeah,
I guarantee they have.
No, well,
if they have, like, they have to get a shirt or something.
Yeah, they get free stuff. If you find it, we're gonna get some free stuff for you.
There's not enough.
Too many mistakes.
Oh shit! By the way, the losers went into a coughing fit. Both of them went into a coughing fit just now. Like, wait, don't just give away stuff every time. Every time we do, it's a lot of pressure.
You're just gonna go in the office and see them enroll in a class. Fucking grammar.
Lou and the Lou's will put a dollar into a jar every time you guys catch a
thing. Dude, if you guys catch a PDA,
and we
PDT.
And when we get it, we get Jacob a hooker.
Yeah, that's true. We're going to get a $10,000 high price escort for
Jacob.
Oh,
this is going to be high end. GFE, girlfriend experience.
PDT, for listeners, what the segment's title, what you're seeing on the radio screen.
Stop fighting us so much.
Wait, so
you're going to get this hooker, Jacob. Look at all AMW. He's like, seriously, take pictures, send him in.
I need proof. I'm trying to take down this.
You don't want any mistakes? You
want
a flawless show?
It's kind of funny that people can look for it now, though.
Yeah.
And see.
Well, here's the deal, guys. You guys keep fucking just going. Just keep doing it. And if it happens.
Do you?
Just make one of them a keyboard punch. Just that's the segment. He goes, what is this?
Yeah, dude. I mean, I say really go into it because let's get Jacob this hooker. I mean, you guys are paying for it ultimately. But
I mean, you guys aren't paying for it.
I don't want a hooker. Wait,
why not?
Shark ride?
Shark ride. Shark ride.
You know Ricky Velez makes velour shark saddles. Remember we were talking about that with Pete?
Yeah. You got to, shark ride.
Shark ride.
We're saving up for a shark ride.
So you can go swimming with the shark.
The Lou's are going to mistake their way into you riding a shark.
This is why you did this, right? To get your shark ride? This is why you... broke your friendship up with Black Lou and White Lou.
Why'd you be in the radio if the end game wasn't some sort of a shark ride?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't want to know a man whose end game isn't a shark ride.
A shark ride?
Just on a saddle, whipping that thing
riding
around.
Riding a shark, living as a shark for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Until you run out of bubbles.
I get what you're saying, Jacob. You don't want it to look sloppy.
No,
you want it to look professional.
Principal.
Yeah, I know.
Professor.
You got to rein down this shit.
You're not the school principal. You're the professor.
You're the boss of the Lewis.
I do run a channel.
And you make it known.
I mean,
you know what? I'm sorry.
I run a channel. I got to have it. It's got to look good.
You're right, Jacob. You run an entire channel. You're the dean.
I'm doing this for the... This is the show.
Headmaster Batat.
Headmaster
Batat. Can I have some pudding before I eat my meat?
Chancellor Jacob. Chancellor Jacob.
Yes, you. You can't have any pudding until you eat your meat.
You have to eat your meat if you want your pudding.
How can you have any pudding if you don't eat your meat? Okay. Yes, you.
Sorry for having pride. please continue with the show.
I'm sad and embarrassed.
Sorry,
Jacob.
I brought it up.
Hearing stamping.
I'm not. Wait. So he does. White Lou does them live because
there's
a White Lou's.
Jacob, leave those Lou's alone.
No, I'm talking about the Thursday show.
come up with it. We'll think about this. But Lou, you're on notice, bro. All right.
Hey, did you guys hear that Jacob is a trained actor off Broadway?
Okay, that you are trying to deflect.
I sure am.
You are trying to deflect. There's a lot of stuff to get to. Brendan Dessy's out.
Well, hang on a second. It's a good job, Lou. Because now all I can think about
is monologues from Jacob.
Is monologues by Jacob.
The city always wasn't what it was. I remember back when I was growing up here. Call the guys in the neighborhood.
Hey, yo, Jacob, where you going?
One man show.
One man show, Jacob.
Yes. You know, it wasn't easy for me growing up. I was in the streets, a kid, in a tough neighborhood.
Hey, Jacob, you better go home.
He's just doing the same voice with Shitty.
He's just doing John Leguizamo's freak.
Yeah, yeah.
He goes, so I walk over to see my papi and my mommy. Because it was time to have some rose confoyo. And I remember she'd be hanging out the window going, Jacob, Jacob, esta cabaña en la cama, en la cabaña.
Jacob, how long did you act for?
I don't know, like three or four years.
Told me ten.
Whoa.
Good deflection, by the way, Lou.
Oh, this is starting from inter- By the way,
you are the stars, and Juliet is the sun.
Yeah. What plays have you done?
Orphans.
Okay.
Newsies.
Oh, please do Newsies. Please say you played all of the Newsies. You just had to put on different hats and come out and sing.
Modigliani.
The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. What was the second one?
Modigliani.
What is that?
It's the. It was a play based on the painter's life.
Did you play the painter?
No. It was his friend.
Okay.
Trio.
Did you do Shakespeare? Person. Any Shakespeare?
Not on stage. No.
Not just at home alone with your Mom teddy bears?
Was. Yeah.
What other shows? Funny Girl.
Cats. Please say Cats.
Cats?
Please say Cats.
No musicals. No, so can't
not
sing.
A sound from the pavement.
Mom, good news. They just cast me as Mr. Mustafi.
Because the moon lost her memory.
Did you do Hello, Dolly?
John Patrick Shanley play Italian-American Reconciliation.
Did you do, like, risque art where you were, like, naked in a box?
No, God, no.
Did you do any monologues in these things?
I think I had one monologue.
Got a sound from the pavement.
Thespian Jacob. Excellent deflection, Lou. You're still going to family court, but good God.
Fantastic.
You just oop that in.
Can someone make a picture of a mouse wearing a cat suit?
Oh.
If I can deflect back.
Due to my principles, I cannot be in Cats.
By the way, the live show, you know how many people still don't know, was Mark Norman there?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
Not? Oh, yeah.
Not a strong deflection. I want to see Jacob read a scene with me, a famous scene.
But, Jacob, where the fuck you at?
Yeah.
I'm going to be back in action pretty soon.
I know you are.
Back in the game?
Word on the street.
To be able to work out. And
hell, yeah.
Dude, I cannot wait to see you next summer.
Yoked.
You want to do some fucking human growth hormone, Doc?
Yeah, dude, let's get fucking yoked.
Dude, Jacob, you want to do some human growth hormone?
We can get it from Mexico, I'm sure. Dude, we know a guy who knows a guy who's met Joe Rogan who can get us some fucking junk.
I was in high school, some kid, he was on steroids, and we were in the gym.
Yeah.
It was a gym class he had to work out. It was a little weight room in our high school. He was on steroids, and he said, I was a scrawny kid. I mean, a toothpick. And he said, dude, I want you to punch me as hard as you can in the stomach, and then I'm going to punch you in the stomach as hard as I can.
Why would you do that?
No, I didn't want to.
Yeah,
I kept telling him, look, I don't want to punch you. This is not really going to fair.
Why don't you say the truth would have been, I don't want you to punch me.
Yeah, the truth
not,
is,
I don't want to punch you.
I mean, like, you're walking away from that situation with very little damage.
One of those masculine things where he was just saying, you're not a pussy, are you? That type of thing.
Yeah, dude, there was this guy.
And
did you do it?
You sucked his
dick. Had no choice. I
blew him. I did it. I took him in my
punch him in the stomach.
I took him in my mouth.
I accepted him in me.
I punched him in the stomach.
How'd that go?
He felt nothing. It was like a mosquito bite for him. And then he said, "All right, dude, you ready?"
Did you bolt?
And now I was terrified. And I went, and he went right in my gut.
I'll tell you, if you tighten up.
What did you do?
The noise.
Can you do it again?
Because I was trying not to show anything. It was clear he had destroyed my inside.
Yeah, but do the noise again.
Dude, it was it hurts so much.
Oh my God, he's on steroids and he punched you, Jacob. I'm
full
surprised.
Force.
I'm surprised he didn't shake your spine.
Uppercut to the. I remember.
If you tighten your guts up, though, you can get away with that with minimal pain.
I mean, here's the thing: when you let go and then you go, because your solar plexus is still fucking rocked, and you're like,
Jay, I tightened.
Yeah.
It did nothing.
Did nothing. Well, I think it did something.
It helped.
Jay and I on the train ride to work today were singing Simon and Garfunkel's Jacob.
Asking only workmen's wages, I went looking for a job.
I get no offers. Just a come on from the horse on 7th Avenue.
I do declare there were times when I was so low. Some I took some comfort there. La la la.
Well, we said if we were late 45 minutes, you just have a gun in your mouth singing.
Yes, hello, darkness, my old friend. Here we have it. I've come to talk.
Can you keep up?
I'm looking at one more time.
No, you've done too much mathematics and watching.
You're overthinking it. Here's, look, Jacob, here's my advice.
Free your mind.
If I can, because by the way, in my head, I've already done it 12 times. Here's my advice.
I do it every morning as I wake up.
You lay on your back. You take your legs. You really roll. You try to roll up into a ball. They say you should see your own feet.
Yes.
Hands planted and really push with the hands up and then kick the feet and try
kick
to follow
up,
your body around.
Kick up and try to follow your body up.
You push, though. You got to push hard.
Dan and Jake, kip up.
You're going through the roof.
Now, only if you practice, remember, your
body. Oh, he almost got it! It's Christine, where were you? He almost got it!
He's so upset because he got so close.
Can you do it? You can do it. You want to do it again?
You can do it.
He got so close.
He's got it.
Somebody's got it.
Sorry, Christine. I know you're in your corner office. I know that you're corporate, Christine. I know you can't.
I've paid my dues. My curtain call.
Yeah, that was awesome.
You give me fame and fortune, everything goes with it.
That was awesome.
That was awesome.
That was so awesome.
How do you feel?
I feel good. I feel strong.
You're like a little ninja.
I feel like you need to do that every morning. You walk around that kind of confidence, you'll be married in no time.
Just escape into the rafters?
Yeah.
Bye, guys.
Smoke. Oh, man. And it's Monday, too, and we don't have Debbie. Debbie D's not across the way anymore.
Are they gone?
No, I saw them. I saw them too.
Where?
On
Wednesdays. I think only on Wednesdays. I saw them when you guys were on vacation.
Now it's Wednesdays?
Oh, that's
because we have to get him back in. She has to see Jacob do a kip up. I mean, that's big. That's big. That would turn it all around for her. She likes athleticism.
She's like, I got to go to the bathroom real quick.
Why?
I bet Ben can't do a kip up.
I'm going to go flick Bean. What?
I bet Ben can't do a kip up.
Not a fucking chance in the world.
I love Jacob's new confidence in his kip. I love his kip up confidence.
Oh, Jacob, you're gonna bring up the fact that you can kip up 12 times in the next.
I imagine him standing at the urinal next to Ben, and he's like, "Hey, Ben, I got a question. You can you kip up?" Hey, Ben,
that'd be great.
Bet you can't kip up.
I don't know. I say I love her. You say you love her. Let's have a kip up contest over it.
Kip up for her heart?
I've never tried it, but I've seen videos. I'm sure I can figure it out.
All right, man. You're packing a thin one, huh?
Oh, kip up, I believe everybody can do that.
Right, you do. You're a trainer. You should be able to do a kip up. Dude, that was impressive.
Any trainer that makes money would be able to do a kip up.
Jacob could be like that. I bet you could. I bet in an alternate world, Jacob's vicious. Vicious Jacob?
You believe he turns up?
Yeah, he goes, "Hey, Andy, can you come over here? They're just looking over some of the edits."
That's so funny.
You made him. Yeah. Right into the keyboard.
Be funny.
I'm sorry.
Jacob's wildly abusive to women. We have no idea.
Oh, just mean flick cigarettes at him after he comes.
Yeah.
He goes, "I'm going to put this goddamn Newport on your back, you fat whore."
She goes, "Jacob, can we watch a movie?" He goes,
"I didn't ask you a question. If I asked you a question, I'd want an answer."
We're going to watch the Speedy Gonzales Comedy Hour.
I love cartoons. Get into it. Tom and Jerry. Want to know why? The mouse wins, you dumb bitch.
You stupid whore.
Vicious Jacob.
You know it's lip like that that got my last girlfriend her jaw busted for her.
I like when someone says they're going to do like something violent to, like for you. Like, want me to bust your jaw for you?
You want me to bust you up a little bit?
Hey, you want me to break your arm for you?
Well.
Oh, is this your first dog? Oh, dude, I saw.
This is probably number 5, just because it's like one of those Titanic dolls. Like, you see the doll head on the bottom of the ocean next to the Titanic.
Yeah. It also looks like dance. It looks like a dance mom.
This is an actual China doll. I mean, that's China. Like, it's or porcelain or whatever. So links.
What do you think you could get on the web for that?
Arrested?
Because fun fact about this one, it actually has a working vagina. So
yeah, that one looks like a soul trapper, right? Like the like a beauty queen.
They all
a beauty queen from the 20s.
Yeah, where all of a sudden you just hear one of those like ding ding ding, those music boxes playing.
Yeah.
Oh, found a hippie. Does this not wear a bra?
Hairy armpits.
Yeah.
By the way, yeah, all these dolls. I think at some point when you say something about them, when you go, I hate these dolls. I just hate them. And then you walk away, and then the doll, like one tear comes out of an eye.
Yeah. or the head just moves. All right. That was number 4. Wait, bring back number 4.
Wait, Jacob, hold up 5 again so I can get a picture.
The one that creeps me out, I got them right. This is the eyes move, the ones that really creep me out.
The eyes move on that one?
Can I ask you a question? Does your mom just get geeked out? Does your mom just get geeked out for dolls? Is she just like, I fucking love, like if she's walking by a store, she's like a doll store. Oh, Murphy.
She hasn't collected them in a while, but she's, I don't know how she got into this.
Jacob, pay me not to tell your mom that you jerk off on her dolls. Pay me not to.
Oh my god. The first thing you do is you go, I think it's so great you let Jacob masturbate onto those dolls.
I know he's very lonely right now during this quarantine, this tough times.
No, if you met her, I'm talking about you meet her in the future. You meet her at like a live bonfire and you're like, this is my mother, and you're like, the fact that you let Jacob masturbate on those dolls is so sweet of you. She's like, excuse me?
Come say what?
If I was gonna J-O to anyone, it would be this one, because it's she's like mature of age. Like what? I would say she's about 20.
That's a good-looking doll.
Yeah, I mean it's a woman. Man,
that lady has a fucking wig on. That's like a cancer wig. I'd be like, that's a ball
for sure. Yeah, for sure. She threw some shit.
That woman can eat out of the garbage comfortably. I don't trust her.
That's pretty eerie.
Number 3.
She looks like. Yeah. I mean, if that thing was in a room, I wouldn't be able to sleep. I'm telling you that 100%.
Well, all of these so far.
Now this one, this was a close number 1, but I.
What are we at now? What are we at now? Right now, is this number 2? This is the runner up.
Now this one freaks me out. It's not as a. Watch the eyes. They open and close and they...
I just did it.
Yeah, why is she dressed like fucking Mork from Mork?
Nanu Nanu, weirdo. You're fucking scaring the fuck out of me. Ah!
Danny, save me.
Help me,
the man. Find the man who put me in this doll.
I put her soul in that doll.
It looks dead when it's laying down with the eyes closed. It looks like it's dead.
Yeah. No thank you. Still got a heart on, but no thank you.
Jacob, just throw them out and tell your mom they all died from SIDS.
Yeah. Say they got corona. Say you heard that corona travels in doll hair.
My number 1.
Number 1, scariest doll at Jacob's mom's house is...
I think you've all met this one before.
Yeah, we have. I don't like fucking Slender Man.
Yeah, it really looks like a haunted drawing.
It does. It looks like somebody just like...
Alamina feet.
That thing's so fucking creepy, I can't take it. I have the picture of it laid out with the two other dolls on the bed.
It looks like somebody erased Gary Goldman's face.
Yeah. Looking at that, it always looks like, it just makes me think of like children with like no eyes, you know, like for some reason.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like that fucking, ugh.
This is
it does, it looks like the pig from Saw.
The hair is grotesque.
It really is. Oh, yeah.
She's got a good Jerry curl.
It looks like the guy at Sirius used
I'm
to be a.
Lie.
It looks like the guy from Sirius. It looks like the guy at Sirius in the hallways used to be an MTV VJ.
Yeah. That guy always looks through me whenever sometimes we're in the bathroom and I'll try to give him a decent hello and he'll just look right through me and I'll be like, dude, you were on MTV in the 80s.
There's very few nice people walking around the halls of Sirius.
Man, you know what it is? I figured out what it is about Sirius with like guys like that and the
we
people.
Dominate.
Yeah, well, number one, we're the bad boys, so everyone wants to get out of our way. And that's because of you. I'm just there as muscle. You're the true bad boy. You're the heart of the bad boy operation.
I do. I guess surprised for my first and only workplace in many, many years. I got to say, I do go aggressive at the problems more than I think I would say my personality would normally do.
I like it. You're thriving. You thrive in the hallways of Sirius.
They're all going to
be when I touch the thing. But my point. No, spring break, coronavirus spring break. Take your fight off, demon doll.
Chicken fight.
We said to Lou, we want some Brian Austin Green. We want some Joey Lawrence.
Basically, we were looking for teenage heartthrobs that attempted music careers and failed miserably because we're pricks, and that's what we wanted to hear today. And Jacob, the producer, found a Corey Feldman video.
I mean, this
and
is like
our jaws are on the ground.
My jaw's on the ground. I've never seen this. I can't believe I never saw this. We need some volume.
I understand. I know.
So here's Jacob.
Oh,
here he goes.
Looking slick.
One move. Oh, he does.
Yeah, get down the night. Get down the night. Oh, he's dropping it back.
Get it.
Ooh.
Oh, wiggle.
Get down the night.
There it is. Whoa.
Murkface, you are...
The last move I'm very proud of.
That was a good
Murkface,
move.
Murkface, you're the Spielberg of awesome. Is this part two now coming?
Yeah,
I heard
yeah.
This is the one where you really bust it wide open.
This is 14. Okay. Here it is. Get it. 1, 2, 3.
Ooh. Yeah. Yeah, feel it. Look at that. Oh, look at that hip work. You look like... Oh, dear, young Danny Terrio.
Oh, he's still, he looks like him now. He's just moving like him. That was great.
That would just make me happy.
That was, did you dance with any ladies that night, Jacob?
We were all in a group. It was all a work group.
You know, me and Soder.
Yeah, I mean, I was dancing with everyone I knew.
Me and Soder both got these while we were in hotels, and I got to tell you, that video, the reason that maid walked into a nice full bone.
Was because of, which move of Jacob's was it? Was it this one, the...
It's man, I'll tell you what, the in and out gets me pretty good. Christine, could you show me part one again, please?
I'll tell you, this was my favorite one. Like, can I show you my favorite one? My favorite one was this. Was the,
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a pretty good one, but I'm a big fan of when he, like, drops back, like...
Oh, okay, now again, at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat.
This will be the most watched video we've put out ever.
Yeah, oh. Jacob just
the confidence. Look at that, the kick out.
Tearing up the dance floor. He comes in right now. Oh. You gotta understand. Oh, there it is. He does a little Harley ride. He does
back
a little
up.
Motorcycle ride.
Back down, up. Down back up, Christine.
Down to the floor.
Like, back up more.
Yeah, back
that's
up more.
That's my spot.
Right here. Oh, right there. There's that move.
Foot goes out. Crossover. Yeah. Does a crossover. Ball, heel, turn, kick.
Yeah.
Oh, there. That's my Yeah, that's it. The motorcycle rev.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Oh.
I like when it goes all the way down here, and then it comes back up.
Dude, next commercial break, we're coming back to some motorcycle rev. We're doing it.
Jacob's a big bad, he's the big bad biker leader.
Man. That was just awesome.
I wonder if it's like music.
Feeling
was,
it.
Dance with pride. What? Goddamn right.
You should dance with pride.
I had a great time.
8, 9, 10. All right, Jacob, here we go. Get out there and show them. Ready?
You didn't buy these orthotics for nothing.
You got those tape. Billy Blanks taught you everything he knows. This is just Tybo with a little bit of rhythm. And 1, 2, 3, 4.
Just let it fly.
Ride the bike. Rub it out. Get down. Get down. Touch the floor. Get up. Foot cross. Spin around. And one time. Go. Go down on my knees. Grab my own shirt. Pull myself up.
Oh, I'm going to save that convention center.
I'm going to save it. Yeah, it's electric. It's a break in three.
Electric boogaloo?
Yeah. Jacob, yeah.
Oh, man.
Still no women admitting to hooking up with men aggressively. I don't believe you.
I know you whores are out
there.
Oh, shut up.
They won't call in if you call them.
They know that I'm kidding. But, I mean, it's going to be a hoary story. But look.
Yeah.
got my own flow. Blunt in my mouth, and these haters I'm scoping. I'm just twisting my body from side to side. I'm just twisting my body.